「抱きしめたいのち」 Okay, time to do the old-fashioned thing.
A lot of chain weaponry.
Yeah.
That's a cornate berserker.
Yeah, I think it was. I don't know. I killed it in like 8 turns. I wasn't paying attention.
If it kept charging you at melee and kept screaming, it was definitely a cornate. If not,
Well, he
it's
wasn't
either a
yelling blood for the blood throne.
the blood for the blood gun and skulls for the skull
Gold
throne. Then
throne,
it's
but
not.
yeah, no,
Then
it's
it's
not in
not that.
corn.
So better chance it's either a red corsair or my favorites, word bearers.
It probably was a ward barrier.
Yes. My favorites. I love just
It,
how they look.
honestly, I was surprised when they showed up. I was like, oh shit, Chaos Marines, fuck you, let's go.
But I mean, ward bearers aren't exactly the ones to just jump in and kill you. Those are the kind of guys that just do some plotting and scheming on the back. That, or I don't know, maybe just felt like it. Ward bearers are pretty flexible on stuff.
So yeah, it was most definitely a war barrier.
Or maybe it's just a red corsair, which, I mean, they're kind of renegades. Chaos. They're also red.
It's probably that.
I don't
But
know, I
yeah,
just don't.
no, it,
I'll
like
see
I
it for
said,
myself then.
yeah, like I said, it's $40. It's worth it.
I'll check my findings and see if I can divert $40 for this. Wait for a sale.
I mean, I posted the trailer in member chat.
Yeah.
Member chat, where? Where is it?
In this Discord.
Oh, there it is. Okay. I'll check it myself. For I am the only Warhammer nerd that knows this shit.
I mean, Ark knows his shit.
Who?
Ark? Archivist?
We're live,
Oh,
by
yeah,
the
that's
way.
Dark Mechanic.
Okay.
That's Dark Mechanicum stuff.
So, how's everyone's day?
Yeah,
Doing all right. I've
doing
had
okay.
my fun. I hate the representation of the fucking space furries. I loathe
Right.
them.
You know what? You get a Sister of Battle in your team.
Oh, the big wreck thing? That's the space marine. I think that's a fucking. That's not just a space marine. That guy is a, what you call it? A hell brute. And yeah,
Yeah.
those are basically the worst version of a dreadnought, because you're entombed there while alive, and mostly demon muscles are controlling you. And yeah, that's definitely a word bearer.
Okay.
Which means some of this stuff may actually be something. There might be a chaos plot somewhere.
So far, yes. As I can tell, like they're really focusing on like the warp and how it will corrupt people and all that. I literally had to execute a guy because the corruption wouldn't leave him. I was like, fuck you. I ain't dealing with that shit, just kill him.
Sometimes the perils of the warp are too dangerous to understand. And sometimes the taint can only be freed through death. It's rare, but tends to happen.
So, Lone, any video games that you were looking at or wanted to play and or
That was kind of
thinking
obvious.
about?
That was kind of obvious with the thumbnail.
Oh, is this the new Gundam game?
No.
He's gonna play Zone of the Enders or that other big
Ah.
butt game.
Hey, show Fall of Cybertron some respect.
Yeah, I was going to, but I didn't feel like playing it. Maybe next time. Like I played it, and I'm like, man, I'm not in the mood for this. Maybe it's because I'm transforming out. at the moment because I've been like retreading like 2007 onward. And yeah, I've seen a new trailer. I don't know if we can actually talk about that or not later on, but I'm mixed on that one.
Do you like how things are getting more comic-y this way? Just the fucking quippy dialogue, like, you know, like that other movie and that other movie.
Yeah.
It's basically just all of them.
Yeah.
There is no soul anymore. I keep saying sometimes dead is better.
Mm.
This situation is just a pure representation.
Yeah. Like, on one hand, pre-war Cybertron. On the other hand, also random humor, dialogue similar to other movies' dialogue, that type of shit. And that's a real shame, though. But, like, part of me is like, oh, that's kind of cool, but they're borrowing aspects from the lore from the comics, but only aspects. They're like, Megatron's not a gladiator, and Optimus, who is Orion, but Megatron is not Megatronus, which is bullshit. But Orion's not a clerk. He's not a librarian, basically, checking the Iacon archives and stuff like that.
I haven't seen the trailer. What is he? Or does he not say?
I didn't know say. They're just worker bots. Basically, they can't transform their worker bots, which aspects of that is in lore. Like that's how Decepticons kind of got made, was because of pre-war Cybertron. If you were tasked with something, it had to do with your transformation. If you transformed that thing, that's what you were bound to. So if you were a truck, you transported stuff. If you were like a big hammer or something like that, like you mine minerals, that type of stuff. It was a very like classist like type system, and Megatron did not like that system at all, and that's how we got the Decepticon following that it did. And because the Decepticons were primarily the Defense Force, the gladiators and like other types that followed like Megatron closely, that's why they were winning at the beginning.
Yeah. But then they start doing a lot of war crimes, and
Well, Autobots did war crimes too. Then, because if you count the Omega Supreme and the other Defense like Force bots, like they themselves did some messed up stuff too. But like,
yeah, but were they as bad as the DJD or Shockwave?
Oh yeah, that's a good point.
Man, I will say that is I give IW credit for that. That's one of the scary. That's basically like the SS. But, like, they're just scary, man. They're just horrifying.
I find this to be quite logical. Got Prime as a... That version of Shockwave is awesome. Even though I do prefer the original voice actor who did reprise his role in Animated. And I think Steve Blum did a pretty good job with Fall as well.
Yeah, that was Steve Blum? Oh, he was.
Yeah, that was. Sit there and be a good
him.
Pet.
Was it him and one other did a lot of voices in those two games?
Yeah, him.
I think Bruticus and Cliffjumper.
You hear like Matt Mercer, you hear Owen, you hear like Travis, the Critical Role cast, basically. They were everywhere.
Matt Mercer's becoming the new fucking Troy Baker.
I mean, he kind of was already the Troy Baker. He was Troy Baker of the early 2000s.
Yeah. But hey, you know, he did a really good... He did a really good role as Vincent in Rebirth.
Hmm.
Oh, it was... Nolan North. That's what it was.
Yeah, Nolan North is in a lot of... Yeah, that's right, too. Yeah.
Yeah, Troy Baker and Nolan North.
No, we were talking about Cybertron. We were talking about Cybertron.
Oh, yeah.
A bunch of voice actors were in the game.
Everywhere.
Yeah.
Like, a lot of people don't realize it, but then you realize it. Then just kind of hits you like a ton of bricks.
He's a good voice actor.
Yeah. He's got a lot of range. God damn it.
I still can't forget him having, you know, playing Deadpool in the Deadpool game.
I mean, and then, Hulk versus...
No, he wasn't Deadpool in the Deadpool games. They tried to get him, but he did a... I believe it was somebody else.
No, that was Nolan North.
Yeah, that was him. That's really his cadence. And yeah, he was also in that Hulk game. fucking movie. Sorry. Because, I mean, I kind of wish we had more of that stuff. Because it sounds fun. Do you wonder whenever it's going to be time, whenever we're actually going to hear the guys from like Team 4 Star, any other people starting to dub on TV shows?
I don't know. It depends. Like, how long do you think people are getting take? People are getting fed up, like, already. People are getting fired and stuff like that.
Damn, alright.
Like, to an extent, because the whole, Oh god, doggone it. Like the translation fiasco. The translation fiasco that happened.
Here's an option. Just fire them. Just straight up. Straight up, fire them. Done. You guys wanna fuck with the script and all that? Make it woke and all that? Okay, you're fired. We're gonna hire somebody else who actually translated.
I miss the boss heads are also woke, or at least economically, or actually believe it, you know?
I mean, there's incentive and profit. These guys are mostly going for profit.
Profit's waning, though.
Just remember, the guy's the owner of Sweet Baby Inc. is the brother of the guy who Zoe Quinn got killed.
Yep. No, the sister to Alec. Alec,
yeah,
the
brother. Fucking... The sister, sorry. Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Ooh, that upscale.
Yeah.
It was like a dang Blu-ray. Oh,
trust me. Trust me.
You good?
Yeah, I'm good. My brain just stopped working for a second.
I see.
Hold on, I gotta reset it. Yep, I'm good. Alright, but with English voice actors, I believe the ones who actually aren't part of that woke bullshit and all that diversity hire and all that shit are better off being a freelancer and all that. Yeah, because I understand that they want to be part of a union and get more money and all that, but at some times it's like they're demanding more money for a role that, yeah, you are the voice, but we can easily replace you. You can't easily replace somebody who's, I don't know, the coder or the game developer or a fucking layouts person, user face interference person. Like, those guys are hard to replace. Fucking voice actors are easy to replace.
Yeah, but
unless it's a very iconic role, like what's his name? The guy who voices Optimus Prime.
Peter Cullen, Frank Welker.
They're replacing him.
They've been meaning to. He's getting old, but he keeps coming back occasionally.
Yeah, he keeps coming back because he's voice that of good. Mario.
Well, that was only action. That was only that live action. That was only the movie.
No, he's going to be the new voice of Mario from now on.
Wait, Chris Pratt?
It's Chris Pratt? No, where'd you hear that shit?
Not Chris Pratt's going to be the new voice.
Wait, what?
Fuck's sake. Fucking Vincent.
I see. The Arizona internet's really affecting him these days.
And that tumor.
Yeah.
Kevin Foggy is the new voice of Mario.
What? Kevin Foggy. Is that the dude who owns Disney?
That's Kevin Feige. Feige. Afghani. My dyslexia will not help me with that.
Kevin Foggy.
It's a Frenchie voicing an Italian.
Hold on.
No, that's just funny.
Actually, he's an American. He was born here in California.
This was a while ago. What was this, last year when Rise of the Beast came out? The G.I. Joe crossover? Funny enough, I know Mario. Yeah, go ahead, Vincent.
He voiced Mario in Super Mario Wonder. And Luigi.
Okay.
So, yeah.
Did they change the voice of Mario and Luigi?
Well, that's too late now.
What'd you say, Alex?
Did they actually change the actual original voice of Mario and Luigi?
Yes.
Oh, dang. That sucks.
You just confirmed that, right? Please.
Wait, what are you going to say alone?
No. Like, you had, well, I actually heard a screen, there was some PG nudity there. There was nothing explicit, though, but it was like Gundam nudity, you know what I mean? It was like some new type shit.
We're gonna say before that, though.
Oh, yeah, I was talking to Antonio, and it was like in regards to Rise of the Beasts. Funny enough, that is kind of cool. It doesn't entirely surprise me because of several things. One, Transformers and G.I. Joe has been established in multiple continuities and versions that they share the same universe. That's been apparent since G1 and the comics. Yeah. Oh, Cobra Commander actually shows up in an episode of Season 3 of Transformers, of the original show. And Paramount has been meaning to do a G.I. Joe like Transformers movie for a long, long time. Like, since, I believe, either the third or fourth film. Like, originally in 5, like, at the climax, G.I. Joe was supposed to show up at that, but they changed that last minute. Or changed that at a point. So it doesn't shock me here that in Rise of the Beast, they actually, like, just said, screw it, fuck it, like, just put him in, just put him in. They put him in. G.I. Joe, main dude, gets a card and says, oh, G.I. Joe. And I was like, oh, okay, that's kind of cool. But, yeah. I think my only, like, issue with that is, one, G.I. Joe already has been rebooted with the Snake Eyes movie. Now, even though Rise of the Beast takes place in, like the 90s, does this take place in Snake Eyes' continuity, or are they doing a different, like, reboot altogether once again? The Snake Eyes didn't do all that well, so that, I don't really know. I can't comment on that. So it's been a while.
That probably even came out.
Yeah, see, exactly. That's my point.
Yeah, they're probably going to fucking do a remake. Let's be honest. They probably are. Like,
because of how remakes.
Make something new, guys. Don't remake shit.
But it's not financially secure.
I don't give a fuck.
Yeah, the thing is, like, if you want to do a Transformers, G.I. Joe crossover, there's actually a decent comic run I need to get more issues of, but it was basically, it was World War II, and was it Cobra, I think, found Decepticons. It's actually kind of interesting.
Oh, yeah.
Even if
they
use M16s, which, that, you know, hurts my tism.
Yeah.
They have, like, Vietnam-era equipment.
Yeah, that's always been an issue, is how humans can stand up to Cybertronians. That doesn't work for me unless they like have technology that can actually like stand up to them. Like IDW did something clever where they just reverse engineered the technology. I mean, hell, which makes is sense. A bit stretchy even there, because animated like takes place in an alternate, like, what, 2010, 2016, something like that, because Isaac Sundeck was able to reverse engineer Megatron, like, through Megatron. So that's why, like, Detroit's all futuristic and cyberpunky in that universe. But even then, like, they're like the robots,
it's
in that
Detroit.
Yeah, it's Detroit. It's Detroit, but it's better, and there's no RoboCop. But, like, none of the robots this or
Detroit
weaponry in that.
War.
Yeah, none of the weaponry or robots in that universe could even hurt Decepticons. Like, Starscream was just wiping the floor with, like, the Air Force and everything. So.
Well, yeah, because also, was it Prime?
The Air Force.
Yeah.
Okay, for in Prime, they kind of tried, but Prime, its military is weird. Cause there's like a mix of modern day and like 1960s America army. It's kind of weird.
Yeah.
What's that one with the, as I hate to say it, the over sexualized fucking motorcycle?
Which one?
Oh,
RC?
Prime.
Which
RC.
Which one?
Okay.
RC. RC's always been the sexy bot. What are you talking about?
Wait, what do you mean the other one? You mean like Flame War?
You said
who's
blue
the other sexy one?
There's a pink one.
Yeah, RC's
pink.
Yeah, RC has been pink. RC has been pink and blue.
Oh, yeah.
Are you talking about okay, so is this show CGI?
Yes, I'm trying to remember, and it had that one weird guy who was able to inherit Sparks, the Optimus Prime spark.
Wait a minute. How old's the show?
Let me look it up.
Is it the old animated, like the
is
old
it
anime
Beast Wars?
One?
Because when he said that, I'm like, wait, that's Beast Wars.
I was thinking of Revenge of the Fallen, but that's not a show.
Beast Wars. Damn. You know James Earl Taylor was supposed to be the Fallen?
Wait, he was?
He was, but they replaced him with Tony Todd last minute. He voices him in the game. So I thought it was a reverse thing. I was like, oh, they got James Earl Taylor for the game. They couldn't get Tony Todd. Nope. They got James Earl Taylor to voice him in the movie, but last minute they replaced him with Tony Todd.
Transformers Prime.
That was Prime?
Yeah, okay, it is Prime. All right.
Yeah. Huh, okay. Yeah. It's kind of funny how it's not a shock the internet's horny for RC. Yeah, in that show.
Very much so.
Very much so.
Well, they had human partners and all that.
I mean, they've always had partners. They've always had human-like partners.
Yeah, Prime had some of the best ones.
Yeah, Prime has some of the best ones. Miko's transition was pretty awesome. To be a record, like, that is how you do a human character.
We have her. I liked, what's his name? The nerd. What's it?
Ralph?
Yeah, Ralph.
Yeah,
Ralph. I think he was pretty good.
He was pretty cool.
Well, cool. Speaking about Transformers, like, my brain went back to Human Partners and that old car one where the guy starts laughing and slams his head against the butt. What the fuck was that anime called again?
What?
Ooh, Unicron Trilogy? Or is this a different anime?
This is a different anime, sorry. It just, Human Partners, and my brain just went somewhere else. I'm sorry. You can keep talking about Transformers while I look this up.
Alright. Come on. Oh, do you, I guess, are there any, like, would you rather wait for an actual, like, episode, or would it be cool to talk about the new TV show for Fallout?
I haven't been watching Fallout. Y'all can talk about it, but, like, I don't know if I want to watch it.
Alright. Or just, I don't know. But, yeah.
Like, I've heard, I knew there were going to be contradictions like a motherfucker, man, but... what I've heard and what I've noticed on 4chan and their posts and stuff like that, I'm like, okay, you're just giving me more reasons not to watch this dang thing, even
what?
Though...
okay, just out of curiosity, I watched the whole show. What did they mention?
I need to check again. There's like a bunch of stuff, especially with New Vegas
that
and stuff
one,
like that.
That one I think was... or yeah. That I think... which I don't know anything about that one. But yeah, they had the Shady Sands mix up. What's the other one?
The bombing in New Vegas at the end, basically.
Nope, that's bullshit. It was not bombed, it just showed it. They showed Vegas, but it was not nuked.
It looks pretty fucked up to me.
It looks fine, what are you talking about? It looked fine to me. Like, what do you mean nuked?
I mean, I guess there was some... contradicting stuff along with, honestly, for the evidence that I saw, it was just that people got pissed because certain things didn't exactly line up to New Vegas, and especially just how they kind of portrayed Mr. House. And I mean, it wasn't...
there is a theory. This is only a theory, and I'm hoping it is true. He was playing the rest of the council for fools, basically going along with it just so he can know what they're up to. That's what I'm hoping, but you're kind of right with that.
I mean, I could say that, but honestly, it's just me kind of interceding because there's no Rene Abishanwa doing the same role.
Yeah, fair enough.
I mean, that's an obvious complaint, but what can you do?
I mean, in the TV show, they got rid of fucking the NCR, basically.
I don't think
why is that fair?
Oh yeah, Caesar's Legion is non-existent. New Vegas is abandoned.
To be fair, the Legion would not last 10 years after the events of Vegas, even if they won. They would have fallen apart long before then.
No, Caesar would have died of his fucking brain aneurysm way before that.
Yeah, then it would have fallen to pretty much Raider gangs at that point.
Yeah.
I mean...
Is that a dummy thick robot? Sorry.
God damn it. What the heck are you talking about?
I'm watching the stream while we're doing
this.
Yeah,
zone, yeah.
Dummy
Can I try and go out on a limb for, like, certain theories for this?
Mm-hmm.
I like to think that maybe Caesar Legion is still there, but in a much reduced scale.
Maybe some of his advisors could hold together, but it would be a lot weaker. Like, it would not be as strong.
Yeah. No, no.
Fairly soon,
how the Legion works is somebody has to be at the top. Done. There has to be one person. It cannot be a company.
I mean,
we don't even wasn't that what happened at the end? What, isn't that what happens if he does die in the game?
Yeah.
If he does die, it does become a...
Lanius
takes over, and then they basically everything becomes shit. Like, we can't keep up. Like, we become so disorganized, they break off and all that shit.
Yeah. But here's something. What if Lanius is still there after all this time, or maybe one of his descendants?
It's only 10 years, dude, so Lanius would be alive.
15.
Yeah.
So my question is, are we going to see a courier?
We see New Vegas, it's intact, so honestly, maybe.
I mean, we could just hear some stuff about him, because I feel like one thing I want for them is do not mention the courier, or don't show him, just have mentions of him. Leave him
You could say the courier's in either the Big MT or Big MT, Sierra Madre, or... Oh, no, not Sierra Madre, but like either Big MT or Utah. You could do that.
That or simply just fucked
or
off.
Or we
so
forgot
well.
The Lonesome Road.
Why would he be there?
Because he's the courier. All roads lead back to home.
No.
And my home's in the good old penthouse.
My honest belief is that honestly he just got tired one day after like 5 years. He just grabbed this stuff and fucked off into the desert.
Which, that actually would be a good enough explanation.
Or he's just still delivering packages out there.
Yeah, I simply went back. I simply, like, after a while, he simply said, fuck it, I'll get back to work.
Maybe the TV show should allude that the courier was there. Like, it's like, yeah, there was this really badass courier who got shot in the head. Tracked down the guy who shot him and shot him back.
Yeah.
If they do a dumb thing where they reveal the courier delivered the nuke that bombed Shady Sands, that would be kind of funny, actually.
You know, that would be funny if he's the reason why the Legion's gone and the NCR is like, he nuked both of them.
Yeah.
That would honestly just be kind of hilarious how canonically he simply said, fuck everything,
I do my own shit.
Fuck you, fuck you, fuck you, you're cool, fuck you, I'm out.
Now my question is, are they going to introduce the followers of the apocalypse?
If they show them as much of an incompetent, like, rich kids, that would be kind of funny. I would love to see that.
No, the followers of the apocalypse were geniuses. They were reusing.
Geniuses, but they were kind of just... Well, the thing about the followers, they are smart. Like, intellectually wise. Street smarts... They have none, and they are also very naive.
And I guess they're kind of unlucky as fuck. They have the worst luck.
Yeah, that too.
If something will go wrong for them, it will.
I mean, look at Arcade. He's an Enclave soldier.
And yet he just wants to help people. Yet he's cursed by his lineage.
Yeah.
No, he's cursed. Although... Yay!
The thing is he can kind of embrace it though, because you do go down his quest. He does not completely embrace it, but he does try to help, obviously, at Hoover Dam.
And then they get shot because that's how it is. They got shot by the.
Shoot, I don't.
They got
I don't
shot
remember the,
by
the
ending
scenes.
Hey, Guardian.
If you keep Arcade with the Enclave and the remnant of the Enclaves, they do get shot by the NCR.
Is that an ending slide?
Yes.
Fuck, I gotta find it then.
Yeah, you have to do Arcade's quest and being scooped.
Oh, I never did. Right, I never beat the game with that character.
Yeah, you have to. Yeah.
God damn, I can't have get in this.
Oh no, I did house that playthrough. That's what I did. That
yeah,
okay, never mind.
If you do the NCR playthrough and all that. The NCR, the NCR's look, everyone's like, fucking Enclave, shoot him! And then they get shot.
God damn, we can't have shit in the Mojave.
Welcome to Mojave, you can't have shit.
What? You can't have fucking redemption.
I mean, the only thing you can have is a trusty sip from your vault canteen.
Fucking Redditor.
Fucked on thirsty, thank you.
Hold on. Oh, that's a good sip.
that everyone is dead?
That is correct. The only thing you can add is press the zipper button.
Alright.
That was a good one, you have to admit.
Yeah, you got us. But I gotta say, I hate how people just constantly pick up that slide of just the final episode as like, this is New Vegas. No, Lolly said it, explained it better. It's just something you see in Passage. It's like some low poly shit you get to see from afar and during the day. It doesn't represent it. I guess eventually we're going to see it again, but in better detail. In season 2. If there is such a thing. In that case, it'll just be the biggest cock block ever.
Right. You know, you're talking mad shit for somebody who's within range of an anti-material rifle.
Your mental condition. I really hope they actually mention some of those. Also really hope they mention, you know, actual good weaponry that isn't that shit assault rifle.
Oh, you mean the service rifle?
Not the assault rifle from Fallout 4.
This is Atlantis. Whoever is aboard Jahuti, can you read me?
As I said,
what
it's
the fuck? Why does it have anti-aircraft sights on a handheld assault rifle? Is it liquid cooling? It can't be because you could put vents on it, but that doesn't make any sense. Like, and the magazine is like, what the fuck is it? Why is it sticking straight out? Like, it's just phenomenally. Why is there a charging handle on it? You know, like, I understand there's a bolt on it, but why is there like a charging handle, like where you hold it and all that? It just doesn't make any sense.
Well, it looks Fallout. It looks gunny.
No, like it doesn't. It doesn't look like a gun. It looks like an abomination upon this earth.
I know, I was just doing the fucking Redditor thing, but I... Why? Who even okayed this? What pathways have led to the... To the okay Todd of Howard. These episodes.
It's all Todd Howard. It all comes back to Todd Howard.
Todd, you son of a bitch.
You did it again. He's be releasing Fallout 4. Of course, I'm talking business. We'll
pay you for your troubles. Oh yeah, that comes out in 2 days, the next gen update.
Oh, for fuck's sake. Skyrim, now it's Fallout. No, fucking hell.
I could get attacked
again. No, this is the second time Fallout 4 has been re-released. Skyrim has been released on the 16 different consoles?
Something like that, yeah.
I think it's more than 10, and that is definitely too much Skyrim.
Alright,
but hey, has it been released on Doom? Fucking the OG Doom? Did you hear that a scientist has somehow use cellular cells to run the first frame of Doom? Let them get a hold of
Jahuti. If they do, what? It will
be the end of they use cells to run the first frame of Doom. The OG
cells.
No, like cells, like please. Cells. They had like a colony of cells, and they're like, "Fuck it, there's enough processing power here in these cells," and they somehow the cells are running the first frame of Doom. Somebody did the math. It's going to take about 773 years to play Doom on those cells.
We have gone too far.
The question is, does it run Doom?
Better question is, does John Carmack found out about this and actually makes it run in 10 years?
I mean, maybe.
Because I swear, that guy is fucking scary with technology.
Yes, Doom is the code of the soul. I mean, we were able to play Doom in Minecraft. It's not with me. I understand.
So, we have a in what way, excuse me?
They were able to use the redstone blocks to access a computer processor. They were able to make a calculator with it, and then somebody used that and furthered on it to make it run Doom.
I can really trust you. That's gonna feel super fucking janky to play with.
I mean, it was. I'm not entirely shocked with Minecraft. People made a working 16-bit computer in that thing.
Yeah.
That's what I'm saying. And then they use that computer to run Doom. The mission
is to transport this. We've gone. We came far as a species, just to fucking emulate Doom everywhere.
See, we haven't gone far enough.
My lamp isn't emulating Doom. It's not far enough. And therefore
has only minimum system capabilities. Okay, let's get to Antonio's things. Anyone else bothered by the shows recently, like Invincible only having like 8 episodes per season? It's just me. I'm rather mixed on it. Like, I myself, 8 episodes a season is nothing exactly new. You can definitely make the argument that it's getting more common, especially on shows like platforms like Amazon. But it depends. Depends on the writer and the people involved. Some cases, 8 episodes can actually be more than enough time to tell a story. Like, I think a good example is the Netflix Marvel shows. Well, they're no longer on Netflix, funny enough. Each season-ish is basically 13 episodes. While the big criticism of most if not all the shows is that they're 2 or 3 episodes a bit too long than they should be. They're all like 10 or 8 episode long concepts stretched to 13 episodes. So, but you do hear the criticism for some shows that are 8 episodes long being meant to be 10 episodes, vice versa. So, in my opinion, it depends on the show in question, though. Like, Invincible, I think, manages its time pretty well, in my opinion, so.
Yeah, and I have to agree with that, because, like, I understand they're only doing 8 episodes. Like, I understand it. We get animes with only 12 episodes a season.
Yeah.
Yeah. I'm right, Jekyll.
So I'm so used to it. I was like, oh, there's only 8 episodes a season? All right.
Yeah.
Is it Samurai done good? Jack. Yep, that's pretty great.
Samurai Jack's Revival only got 10 episodes, so I'd say they got off lucky at some degree.
Let's be real, ReZero has probably done one of the better ones, because they re-released the first season as the director's cut season thing. One episode was 43 minutes long.
Yeah, Psychopass did something similar to that, didn't it? No, yeah, it did. Season 1 had its Hellsing Ultimate. Yeah, well, Hellsing Ultimate was an OVA.
Ultimate was the followed the manga way better than Hellsing.
Yeah, it was an OVA series that took time, but yeah. But Psycho Pass had its own director's cut, and each episode being like 40 minutes long, more scenes, improved animation, that type of stuff. It's honestly, in my opinion, is the definitive way to watch the show, the first season at least.
Okay, but all I gotta say is, right now, I'm fucking tired and sleepy as shit. This is a good chance to tell y'all goodbye, good night, and enjoy whatever you're doing. So, yeah.
Good night. Good night, goodbye, good morning.
So, whatever. Bye.
But yeah. Yeah, you're right with the Blue Eye Samurai. Blue does it extremely well.
Yeah, it does. Yeah, I agree with Antonio there.
Anything else? Like,
no idea. Like, yeah, y'all were just like ramming about like Fallout. I didn't want to like interrupt you. But, okay.
What is Mei Fly?
What?
Mei Fly.
Oh, yeah. So, I'm pretty sure we're all familiar with everyone's favorite Sigma male, Patrick Bateman, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, like everyone's familiar with American Psycho. Now, Mayfly, it takes heavy inspiration from American Psycho, so in that, in the sense that is a extreme horror book. Now, I went through it not that long ago, like I think like 2 days ago, and it's kind of like somewhat fresh in my head, and I kind of actually want to talk about it now to an extent. And by far, probably one of the most disturbing things I've read book-wise in a long while. Through sheer content, and it actually kind of, and hearing the comparison to American Psycho, and like some readers actually say, well, it's not as extreme as American Psycho is, which makes me pause like a motherfucker because I'm like considering the shit that happens in Mayfly. So the fact that it's, oh yeah, it's not as bad as American Psycho, I'm like, holy shit, what happens in that book? But Mayfly follows the main character named Mayfly, and it's basically you are following like a sociopath, a psychopath, like the entire time, and you know, she's trying to take care of her grandma, and she like works in Disney World. It's not explicitly stated, but it's very obvious that that's where she works, and the book also is pretty clever, and it took me a moment to realize what princess she was actually playing, but there is a lot of no, it's actually Elsa. Yeah, her friend is playing Anna, she's playing Elsa, and especially with it becomes very, very like explicit with like what princess she was playing in one really disturbing scene with another character where she's basically like torturing her to the song, to the tune of Let It Go, and as playing in the background. Now
So it's the female version of American Psycho. It's the American Psycho 2. There we go.
It kind of is. Like, well, in a way, she is reading a book as the story goes on. And, like, at a point, like, when you get to that final third, it comes very apparent, like, she was reading American Psycho. Like, where she, like, holds it up and said, like, the final thing she says at the end of that chapter, I forgot what chapter it was. Hello, Mr. Bateman. Was like the final thing she says, and I was like, "Oh, the book she was reading was American Psycho." Wait, area change. There we go. Yeah, like that. I thought that was actually pretty clever.
Why does the robot need tits? I'm sorry, that's just.
I think she left. I don't think she's gonna come back for a while. Okay, I think I said.
Gotta take it a read then.
Okay, like, I think I wrote my live reaction though. I just wanted to, like, talk about or rave about it because. CJ Lee does a good enough job getting you in the head of a vicious monster. And it does do the, like American Psycho, Johnny the Homicidal Maniac, if that's the name of that comic, the guy, the Invader Zim, you know, that guy, that comic, like, as they're, like, saying and stating, like, other things and talking about, like, consumerism, that type of stuff, but, like, it's very apparent that the person talking is very much a hypocrite and doesn't know what the hell they're talking about, like, with
So. He's probably talking from experience by talking to other people because they don't know what the fuck they're talking about.
Kind of, but like with Maeve, it's very apparent that like the person is a walking contradiction. Like, she criticizes other people for liking Disney, but she herself like likes Disney a lot. She herself like likes like Halloween stuff and likes like masks and stuff like that. So there's a lot of hypocrisy, but that's obviously the point. And it took people like a second. Like, I kind of was aware when I got to a point, I was like, okay, that's obviously the point of the character of the story. So
startling smells like hypocrisy. So look,
it's the Catholic Church. You'll read my presence to the world, and you'll live to tell of it later. Except you won't, because I would have killed you. Oh my, that's totally from Boondock Saints. No, it isn't. I came with it a week ago. Boondock Saints. Okay, we'll get veering off course. It is a well-written book. It's very clearly not for the faint of heart in any way. Like, I wouldn't say, like, I'm not squeamish or anything like that. Like, I read through A Song of Ice and Fire to an extent, and I'm a grim dark fairy tale guy, grim dark fantasy guy. So I like me some dark stuff. Here it took me a few times that I was like, okay, I'm gonna pause, I'm gonna finish this later, because there are many moments that are like very graphic. not just in terms of violent, but also like somewhat sexual content. Now, like sexual okay, I'm gonna sneeze shit. Shit. Okay, like sexual content wasn't the issue. Is that because remember Maeve is a fucking sociopath, and the person she's dating, she's fucking, is also very much. And this is kind of, I know I'm swirling, but like, I know, but is also very apparently a psychopath because of the shit they do. Like, first scene they do, they're fucking on the ice skating ring. They're like, she's like, her back is like on the ice, and like the dude like is like a, oh shit, what was he? He's hockey player, and is like his tooth got like messed up. And like at the very end, like she rips his tooth out and shit. And like later on, I don't remember. Like what was it? They kind of have a threesome afterwards with one of their friends that I mentioned earlier. But like Maeve is like literally inches from not inches, but like she inserts a curling iron. Oh shit. Okay, yeah, she inserts a curling iron into her vagina, but is inches from turning it on, and notices, she notices it's her like boyfriend doesn't react.
It's like that one scene from Sleepaway Camp. Got it.
Yeah, but she doesn't turn it on, and she's like, "Hey, this thing can mess her up," and she realizes that he's not reacting, and she's like, in her head, like, "Okay, is he daring me to do this shit?" And she's just screaming. She's just screaming the entire. The girl's just screaming the entire time, with this ball gag in her mouth. And I'm like, and they just, they. She's like, and Maeve is like, okay, I'm hungry. They go upstairs, and she's, and the girl's still screaming downstairs. It's actually like there's some good like dark comedy moments. And yeah, I talked a few more I'd rather not say on stream, honestly. Like I think I talked about a bit more like in the Discord, like the soft boiled eggs, what she does with those, how she was like under contract for a director to do certain things to him. I'm not gonna say what those things are, but yeah. But it's just there to show how like okay and desensitized she is and how deranged she is. Because like when she says like, oh, I try to find it debaucherous, but I just find it rather stale. And I'm just like, you're literally paid to do this disgusting thing to this guy, and you just find it stale. Okay, I need a break. Like that's happened to me a few times. The final third of the book is just you can see me like life.
Don't spoil the book. Like, let the readers decide how they like it. And Lone, you're talking to somebody who have seen all of the Cure of the Wolf shit. Like, I've actually seen the pictures. Like, yeah, that shit doesn't faze me anymore.
Oh dang. Nothing on chat right now. But
yeah, no.
Yeah. Yeah. A lot of dark shit happens in that book, but I thought it was good. It's definitely one of those things I'm probably not gonna read for a while, because I think that one and done is good enough. I thought it was well written to an extent, so yeah, there's that. Mm-hmm. Yeah. I'm gonna try to feed this boss right now. I just had to revisit some of this shit mentally.
You want some more dark, bro? It's okay. I'm already there. You want the light? It's your turn with the light. Anything else, like? How's the new job treating you?
Oh, it's doing well.
A lot better than your old job?
Pretty much, to an extent.
What was your old job?
Don't worry about it.
Okay.
I was just moving stuff out of a truck, that's all it was. My new job is moving stuff out of a truck, but it's only on machinery this time around. So it's a lot less physically taxing, which is actually pretty good.
Are you forklift certified?
Unironically, yeah, I am. That's not even
awesome.
A joke.
We have.
That's not a joke.
Actually, they tried to. So my old job at Goodwill, they all that. They tried to tag me. It was like, hey, use this and all that. And I looked at the manager straight in the eye and go, you haven't given me the certification of forklift. And he's like, what? I was like, I can't use that. I'm not forklift certified. And I walked away. And the manager couldn't yell at me because I was like, I can't use that machine. I'm not certified.
Yeah, they have to certify it. Then get certified, buddy. Get on training.
Well, he's like, it's like a 10-minute course. And I was like, yeah, but that also takes time out of my fucking processing. I'm not.
That's kind of dumb. At least you'd be able to do a lot more stuff with that. And you can, and on your next job, you can put that on your resume and get a better job next time. That's what I did with my job.
Yeah. Well, so. I mean, I'm certified for food safe service. I have my food safe certification. So I think that's a lot better than I'm forklift certified. Like just imagine that putting on my resume. I'm food safe certified and forklift certified. Like, what is that?
I mean, like, you know how to operate heavy machinery. I think that's more important than. I think that's more important than like being in food safety. I'm gonna be frank.
Yeah,
sure. Whatever.
But my job description at the time was I processed the electronics, so I didn't know why they were trying to teach me how to use the forklift. Because I think they were trying to switch me over for the DA, which is basically donations assistance, where I would, you know, move the gaylords, unpack the machine, the 18-wheeler, move furniture around and all that. I'm like, dude, that's not my job. My job is this. I will only do this. If you want me to do more, pay me more, and I will do it. As well as on top of this job. And they didn't like that I said that. I was like, you want me to do more work? Pay me more. They didn't think I would actually stand up for myself. I'm like, no, pay me more and I'll do it. So they hired two new people and they quit within the week. Guy that I thought was funny.
Confirmed ETR reaction from the target. Its main generator has ceased to function.
We did it!
I detect vital activity within the target. It appears that occupants are still alive. I am releasing the lock-on cursor. Target will be destroyed.
Destroy it? Why? They can't fight anymore.
Your question does not compute.
What else is on the agenda?
Why should I kill when there's no reason to?
I compute 17 clear reasons.
Current
for
enemies
such action.
Going on.
Most possibility of the target gaining
Spice and Wolf reboot. I'm excited for that. I'm a huge Spice.
That already came out.
At another time and place.
I know. I'm excited for it. I haven't watched it yet.
Yeah, I've watched episode 1. I'm gonna hold off for a while the other 2 episodes that came out.
Yeah, that's what I've been doing. I'll wait until a few episodes come out. I believe that time I got reincarnated, the slime comes out. Season 3 comes out this year.
Yeah, I ain't watching that. I think the only isekai is like ReZero, Mashoka Tensei. I think are the only ones I'm watching right now, to be honest. Mashoka Tensei came back, and I've been liking that a lot. Even though I know that's not for everybody, but man, I enjoyed it.
It's a good anime. I like it. Like, yeah, he's a pervert, but, you know, I was like, but he's holding back and all that. And the dude goes through some pretty fucked up shit.
I detect several mass-produced orbital frames behind us. They are in the vicinity of the church.
Okay,
enemy with a reinforced program. Be careful.
Loser Ranger, what's that?
Oh, dude, you don't know about that one? Like I think it's based on a webtoon, a webcomic.
Is it the one where the guy joins like the Power Rangers and all that?
He's actually a monster. He's actually infiltrating. Yeah, that came out.
Awesome.
Yeah, I've been liking it.
I was Yeah, I wanted to watch that. Ninja Kamui. Or Kamen.
Ninja Kamui? Yeah, that's been solid. I'm going to wait till the last two episodes are going to drop. Then I'll, I'll finish you that off.
Yeah.
I don't know about that. But it has been really solid, though. The action's actually pretty on point. And it has a pretty neat story, though. Definitely, it definitely has that 2008 feel to it. You know what I mean?
Alavaka wants to know, why does Bethesda keep making cool mercenary factions like Talon Company and the Gunners are so shallow? They don't tell you in Fallout 4, the Gunners are actually part of a Vault-Tec experiment where they just basically breeded the most psychotic and sociopathic people to fight in wars. Like, to fight. That was the idea. So basically they would be trained at a young age at boot camp and all that, and when they turned 18, if you weren't good enough, you were killed. And if you were good enough, they would harvest your genes and splice them with another person to make a better soldier. We have shot down the enemy. We will cease battle position. That's all I remember from it. We have shot down the enemy.
We will cease battle position. Anything else on? I don't know if I want to circle back to Transformers right now at the moment, though. I guess I'll get that topic before. Oh, yeah, Immaculate. You know what? Yeah, I get that one kind of hurts. And this might be more of a subjective thing, but, you know, Immaculate, that Sydney Sweeney horror movie that came out like a few months back, that was very disappointing for me, to be honest. It's inoffensive. It runs at a pretty, I would say, solid hour and a half. I would say its length was good. It was shot well. I think the actors do a good job. My biggest issues with it is the script in general, which is a damn shame because the writer-director is the same guy who did Voyeurs, and I actually think that movie is pretty spot on. I think that movie is actually well written in some aspects. I think the only issue with that movie is the final like 20 minutes or so, the final like third or fourth technically, because that final portion definitely seemed like he didn't know how to finish the story. But with Immaculate seemed like the exact opposite, where the strength of the movie kind of comes in at the final third, but it's not enough to justify what come before, because I thought it was fairly generic in some aspects. And I'm gonna get into spoilers here. So the main story basically is like Cecilia. She's like this nun, like her old monastery, like kind of got shut down, and she's moved to Italy to a convent over there, and to basically like practice over there. And at a point in time, she discovers that she is pregnant, and like, because she's like a virgin, like the people there, the doctors there are like, oh, she's like Mary reincarnated. And like, you have like some creepy stuff here and there, like a person like comes, she like knew at the beginning as basically calling this out and saying, this is not the case, this is blasphemy, this is blah blah blah. And you see like she hears her like screaming, she tries to investigate, and we see like she peeks in like a corner, and like in this room she's like getting her tongue cut off, and she's like,
yeah,
she's like trying to like to, and she sees this like, okay, I need to get the fuck out of here. It is a waste of time. And she like tries she has an attempt to leave, but they keep her there, and all the way down to and you do get some time skips to her second trimester, to her third trimester, which is basically like their 6 months, 9 months, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
And then at a point where she has her next escape attempt, the twist that genuinely pissed me off and really bugged the film down and turned it to somewhere where I hope it didn't go. I mean, it was unexpected, sure. I wish it didn't go that way. And spoilers. So earlier in the film, we're actually shown that they have like this nail that they basically one of the nails that crucified Christ, and then they have it like in this little glass, little like box on display. And it fucking this screams second draft. So apparently on that, and one of the head priests, and he abandoned like the medical field, basically. That's what he used to be in. And he said, we found something in this nail, DNA. And the moment he said that, it clicked in my head. And I'm like, they fucking are doing Jurassic Park. This is Jurassic Jesus. Like, that is where we're going. I was so fucking livid. I was literally screaming, no, that is not where you're going with this. And this is just not just a pro... They're using her as a surrogate. They're using her as a surrogate to basically give birth to a clone of Jesus, basically. And she escapes. And, burns the little laboratory down. Like, the dude, the priest scientist, like, she ends up setting him on fire. He ends up surviving, and there's your little chase scene in the catacombs, which I thought was well done to an extent. I was mostly focused on the twist and how the writing was done. And then, like, he, like, catches up to her. She uses the nail and stabs him. Like, he dies. She escapes, and you get what is probably like the best scene in the movie, and as the birth scene. Now, the camera just focuses on Sydney's face as she's acting, and it's just her, like, basically just giving birth, because, like, early on, like, in the movie, like, in the third, like, her water broke, like, earlier. So, in this entire time, she's already, like, technically in labor. Now, at this point, like, she's actually giving birth, and it's, like, a good, like, a two-minute, like, scene of just focusing on her, on it, and her screaming and stuff like that, and it's actually pretty well done. And then you hear a plop on the ground, and you hear a murmuring, so it doesn't show you the baby, but it's obvious what happened there. He fucking pulls a Marco from Saga and bites the umbilical cord off. It takes a fucking... Okay. Walks over to some rubble, grabs a rock, and lifts it up, and right before movie ends, you hear a smack, and then the movie ends. It doesn't show you the infanticide, but yeah. Now, part of me wishes that the movie up to that point was different. That right there, I think, was a well-done scene, and I'm going to tell you why I was looking forward to this film. Like, the trailers, the marketing, it looked like somewhat, like, I don't know, art house is the right word, but like an A24 type movie. Like the Vivitch or Hereditary, if you watched either of those two movies. Kind of like that. But this had more of a, like, higher, like, marketing, basically, because this was in a lot of other places. I think this had more, like, marketing than most other A24 films. Like, Northman, I didn't think had that much, like, marketing.
Vodka wants to know, what's the movie called? It's called Immaculate.
Immaculate.
And he also wants to know, is it kind of like The First Omen?
No, I have not watched The First Omen, but there are some similarities, because it does take place in, I believe The First Omen takes place in Italy as well. It takes place in the 70s, and Immaculate also takes place around, like, the mid 70s, or, like, does it take place in the mid? Shit, I forgot.
If it's in the catacombs, then it would be France, because France is the only place.
Well, there's some catacombs, like, under the convent, like, that area, like, one of the Reverend Mothers, like, tells Cece that, like, like, oh, there's some history, some culture here, like a like a great like priest had to have them built and stuff like that, and they're forbidden, it's that type of thing. Like, I don't remember. Does it take place? I think it takes place in the 70s. All right, because everything is in. Because I don't recall there being a cell phone in that movie. I don't recall. Because everything's like you're seeing like old Cadillacs and stuff like that, and old tech. So yeah, it does take place in the 70s. And I think First Omen takes place in the 70s. So there's that similarity, but I can't tell you how like similar or different they are because I haven't watched First Omen. But the biggest difference is that Immaculate is more so, it's technically bio-horror. Not even bio-horror, but like, if you know what I mean. Because there's no supernatural stuff in it, unless you count the fact that the nail has Jesus' DNA on it still. And well, the First Omen is, well, a prequel to The Omen. So yeah, there's that.
Yeah, I guess so.
So you're telling me the nail has Jesus' splooge on it?
Yeah, I guess. It has his bone and his blood on it still. There's remnants of it on it. Which is just straight up, like, flat out of Michael Crichton's Jurassic Park. That is exactly what that's out of.
What's that one movie that turned out to be, like, a really good Catholic movie that, like, at the end you realize it's a Catholic movie? My brain is like, it's not the Da Vinci Code, but is it?
Are you thinking Da Vinci Code?
Yeah, it is. Okay, yeah.
What?
There was a movie I watched, like, years ago. It was like, you didn't realize it was all about Catholic until, like, the very end. I think it was the Da Vinci Code.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Jurassic Jesus sounds pretty supernatural. No.
I mean, like, it's just because it's primarily comprised in, like, biological stuff, and I was hoping it didn't go. Now, like, I don't believe I like, kind of circled back earlier to, like, why I was looking forward to Immaculate was several things. Well, the writer-director who did Voyeurs, who I thought did a good job with that movie, Sydney Sweeney's in it, and before anyone says, oh, yeah, Lone's jerking off to Sydney. One, I was jerking off to Sydney Sweeney before everyone started jerking off to Sydney Sweeney, so shut the fuck up. Second, the trailers actually made it look like an A24 type movie. And thirdly, I was very much hoping this was the case, but this pissed me off that it wasn't, that it was going to be a massive throwback and love letter to a film like Rosemary's Baby. And what I thought that Immaculate was that she wasn't actually in a Catholic convent. She was actually in what at the surface seemed like a Catholic convent, but in actuality was like a place run by a satanic cult, basically. And that she's not giving birth to Christ, she's giving birth to the Antichrist. That's what I was hoping for. That's what I thought they were going for. That's why all this creepy shit's going on. But then the moment he fucking said DNA and bone marrow, I was like, no, you're not going down this fucking road. But they did. They did. And I was like, fuck. And like, it's just littered with a few jump scares. Like, there's a few scenes like neat gore, which I thought was well done. A girl like commits suicide. Isabella, who wanted it to be her, like, there's some neat little hints. They say, no, it shouldn't have been you, it should have been me, which I was, again, kind of reinforced what I thought the film was going to be, but ended up not being that. And she discovers that she doesn't get to be the one who births Jesus 2.0, and she ends up like killing herself. And they like she jumps off like the highest point, and they I'm shocked they still knew it was Isabel, because like they pick her up, they lift her up, and her face like pretty much like is flat, is just peeled off. So it's like her face is just it's meat. So I was like, how the fuck do you know that's Isabel? But whatever. So I think that was well done.
All right.
There's I think the makeup's work was done. I think the costuming was done. I think the way it was filmed was good. The actors do a good job. Sydney seems like she had fun, like she usually does in most of the movies she's in.
Who is Sydney?
Sydney Sweeney.
What she's been in?
Well, Voyeurs, Euphoria, she was in, what was that? Everything. That is another Netflix show. She, oh shit, she was also Anyone But You. That's a rom-com. Like, before, like, Euphoria and her, like, time on Netflix, like, she was mostly in a lot of, like, Hallmark-type stuff, you know what I mean? Like, that was before she was in, but she's actually a really good actress, though. She really gained... Yeah, that is a good point. But, like...
Oh, go ahead.
Yeah, like, after Euphoria, that's when she gained a following. Kind of similar to most other people, like, Jacob Bellarini is his name. The guy who plays, another character, Nate Jacobs, like, he kind of gained a following as well after that show. Zendaya always had her following, to be honest, like, before Euphoria, I think, but,
yeah.
But, yeah, like, yeah, like, let me just... Oh, shit. God damn it, what? Can I get a GIF where tits are not on the screen? Okay,
Nope.
Boobies, surprise, boobies.
Tits alone.
Okay, there we go. She's more modest in this one.
Keep it on your toes.
Yeah, private text chat. There you go. Y'all at home can look it up. There you go.
She's cute.
Yeah, she's a good actress. Like I totally don't follow her Instagram and check up on her. I totally don't like every post she makes. That's not me.
Yeah, she's okay.
Long, are you simping?
No, I'm totally not simping.
Guys, Lone's simping.
I have a question, though.
Yeah.
Did you, so you mentioned she was in Hallmark stuff. Does that mean you were cranking it to Hallmark movies?
No, I wasn't cranking it to Hallmark movies. I was cranking it to Voyeurs and Euphoria. Leave me alone. Get your facts straight. Those are, like, the only, like, that and Anyone But You, too. I think those three things she's naked in, yeah.
Alright.
She's really comfortable with being naked, funny enough. I love how, like, people, like, complain about how, like, it's like, oh, there's a lot of nude scenes with Sydney in Euphoria Season 2, and I'm like, no, they're, like, there's a handful, but no, like, Emilia Clarke was naked more times in Season 1 of Game of Thrones than Sydney was in her entirety of Euphoria. I'm serious. Yeah.
Is Game of Thrones any good?
No.
First, like, season 1 to 4. But at that point, either watch Vikings or you can watch
Vinland Saga.
Vinland Saga, you can. There's, like, a bunch of other shows you can actually watch. Battlestar Galactica is a good show. There's, like, Stargate, do any of the other Stargate. Stargate SG-1, Atlantis, Stargate Universe sadly was canceled, but I like that one a lot.
Don't remind me. You can watch Firefly.
Firefly is really good. That got canceled, but we got Serenity and the comics. Yeah.
That canceled. It wasn't canceled. It wasn't continued.
it was canceled. It was just canceled.
Yeah. Oh, I'm on a dead ship and there's a fucking warp shit's happening. Dead bodies are zooming in, zooming out. I don't know what the fuck is going on. Pretty cool. Speaking about canceled, Wokehammer, Henry Cavill has threatened to walk off the set
if Netflix. Okay, allegedly.
God, that man is cursed.
Yeah, it's official. He has threatened to walk off set if they introduce female commissars. I was like, dude, not commissar.
What is it? Custodian or something like that?
Yeah, custodians. He has threatened to walk off set. And because of that, Amazon is like, maybe?
Because people said that might be the reason why they were added recently into the lore.
Yeah. But according to fucking Wizards of the Boast, everything's canon, so Flash Gifts and Death Knights are canon.
Yeah.
God Emperor Donald Trump is canon.
God Emperor Donald Trump.
You don't understand. I need those Xenos gone. Exterminatus, definitely. You don't understand. My Exterminatus? Exterminatus.
Yeah, the skeletons, get rid of them all.
The filthy Xenos, gone. You're wrong. The orcs are totally British.
Okay. Aren't they like Australian though? At least in the old game
they're Cockney.
They're like very Cockney. Yeah, they're very cool. You're like, but get off my ship, Spice Marine! Spice Marine! They're very cool.
The reason why we shoot the best is because we shoot the best. And we have the best dockers. We gotta docker hard.
And I'm just picturing Joe Biden as the lead. Come on, man.
Yeah, Joe would be a Tao.
No, that's Xi Jinping.
Oh, you're right, yeah.
Oh, yeah. The Weibo space communist says Russian Badger points.
Yeah. They are legit Weibo space communists, though.
Joe Biden would be the one commissar that's actually a badass, but he doesn't remember.
Actually wouldn't make a bit of sense. No, he's only a badass because the orcs think he's a badass.
Exactly, because that's how orc magic works. They think they think so. Therefore,
yeah. Well, I think doesn't it work with like enough where a lot of them have to think the same thing, isn't it? Or
so how it works in lore is if the orcs think it, therefore it happens. So if they think they don't have gasoline. They don't have gasoline for their trucks. But if they say, I did fills it up, then you're like, oh yeah, it fills up. That's just how it works. I mean,
yeah.
Orcs are so stupid and funny. I fucking love it. They're the only ones in the warp who open the windows to do drive-by shootings in the warp.
Yeah. Well, there's also, you ever see like that one little comic where, there's like this one little comic. Yeah, that one.
That's something that can happen.
Well, I love too in that comic, what is it? One of the guardsmen just pretended there was ammo in his gun and they kept dying.
Yeah, and the reason why the orcs yell Daka Daka Daka, because that's the sound a gun makes. And the louder and faster you say Daka, the more gun shoots. Yeah, I agree with Gemini right here. Joe Biden is an orc who conjures ice cream.
That probably wouldn't make sense.
No squibs on him and all that. And he's like, that would make sense. He's like, come on, man. It just works. You gotta believe it. Yeah, this is the most badass ship we have here. It just works.
Fucking Todd Howard.
Oh,
it just Todd works. Howard.
Todd Howard would be an Adaptus Mechanicus.
Weird thing is, actually, you're not wrong.
I'm not. So, Todd, can you explain how this thing works? It just works. Alright.
There you go. We have shot down the enemy. Oh. We will cease battle position.
But yeah, no, Henry Cavill's been getting shit on.
Well, he's the one dude actually gives a fuck. He's like the one autist in Hollywood.
He's a gamer and all that, and he builds his own PCs, and he's a giant nerd.
Yeah, he's the one gamer that has a girlfriend.
Right? Because let's be real, guys, there's no female gamers, it's just dudes.
Oh boy. Insert Sphere Hunter joke.
Did you see Spear Hunter's new cosplay that she did of Eve from Stellar Blade?
I think I did. It's on her.
Wait, is she like Jim Sterling, or can she actually pass as a woman?
Trench, I'm gonna post it in the rev chat and you tell me.
Alright.
Goddamn. Yeah.
There you go, Trench, you tell me.
Ain't the worst, but ain't the best.
Just remember, Shota had a crush on her until she found out.
In all fairness, it could be worse. Like, there's always worse.
Right. All trannies are orcs because that's just how it is.
God damn it. God damn it, man.
I mean, they got the look down.
Yeah, fair enough.
Spear Hunter isn't like Blair White where you have to do a double take.
Yeah.
I know, and yeah. Yeah, no, I did too. I thought Spear Hunter was a female, then I found out and I'm like, hold up! That's a penis.
I will admit, before Iron Liz brought it up, I legit thought she was a woman. I guess you get my point.
Yeah, no, like, I had to verify it, and I was like, no! No!
God. This is what I get.
But Spear Hunter is one of the good ones. We won't shoot her.
Didn't she have, like, a bad take or something?
A few times, yeah.
It was the Dragon Dogma controversy, but everyone was like, why didn't you tell us? And they were like, we honestly didn't fucking know.
What happened to Dragon with Dogma?
So basically, on the release of the game, there was microtransactions in the game first day and all that.
Yeah.
And everyone just started shitting on the game, but then it turns out even the people who got review copies and were able to make reviews on it weren't even told by Capcom that microtransactions were going to be released on day one.
Oof.
And honestly, the microtransactions are for people who can't fucking play video games.
Isn't like one of the publishers Capcom?
The Capcom is the publisher.
Ah, that makes sense because RE4 remake, or actually pretty much every Resident Evil game since 7 has had some form of like a cheat, apparently like a cheat or a way to buy cheats. Seven, you had the coins. 4, you had resources, plus the other suitcases. Fucking 8 was a survival pack.
With 4, I have played it. Those guns you can get in-game if you just progress far enough and all that. And yeah, the tickets are for the ultimate upgrades, which you have to use money to get the upgrade. So it's for people who are fucking lazy and don't play video games.
Like the only things, I think the only things that are the lever action and the big magazine pistol.
It's the pre-order DLCs that for people who didn't have enough money to order the DLCs. With Dragon's Dogma, all that stuff, like the port key crystal, the key, the book, and all that is stuff that you can get in game, and it's really fucking easy. But the camping thing, the camping set. That was part of the deluxe edition and also part of the pre-order. If you pre-order it, you got weapons. So far, the weapons that you pre-order are not microtransaction. It's just, instead of buying all of the deluxe edition update, they spread it out to multiple items. Like, if you just want the camping set, that's fine. You can buy it. That's how they have it work.
All right.
Oh, you're 50 hour, or you're level 50 in Dragon's Dogma 2? That's cute. I'm level 78.
I see.
I know. And also, keep a hold of your port crystals. If you sell them, you won't get them in New Game Plus. I learned that one the hard way.
All right.
But yeah, that's all it is. It's just, wow, okay.
Okay. What?
I'm just looking at the stream and Lump posted a picture of the chicken for the blood in a tunnel. I'm like, nerd.
That's Sydney. That's Sydney on set.
Yep.
That's behind the scenes. That's behind the scenes. Behind the scenes.
Okay, Lone, we get it. You have a crush on her.
I fucking hate you guys.
Hey, I didn't make that. Archno, I didn't make that joke, my man. Reminds me of the blood on her face. What? Oh, fucking Hateful Eight. That reminds me of.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah, that one. Oh, fuck. That does remind me of that. Shit.
I don't, like, I know some people hate that movie. I think it's fine. Oh, it's okay.
I mean, we get to hear Samuel L. Jackson say the N-word.
Also, Walter Goggins is a fantastic actor. I don't care what anyone says.
I fucking knew it!
Oh, and that guitar that he breaks in the movie.
Was an actual antique, and that was a real reaction.
Yeah.
She was like, whoa! And he felt, Kurt Russell felt so bad after that. Like, holy shit. He
bought the guitar and was like, I am so sorry. He spent like $150,000 on it.
Oh, that's a lot.
Yeah, it was an antique. Like, and the thing is, he paid it out of his own pocket.
Yeah.
Speaking out of pocket, the set of Russ, who was it?
Alec Baldwin.
Thank you. Alec Baldwin might be going to jail.
Yeah, he's good. Finally getting tried again. Yeah, I'm aware of that.
Yep. The Armed Smith. She literally got rid of all the dyed hair color and all that and showed up professional and all that. And she's being charged with manslaughter as well.
Good. She should. They both should.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. And apparently she's like, well, I didn't know there was live ammunition on set.
That's your job.
And apparently the only reason why she got the job was because of her daddy.
Yeah, nepotism. Because he was actually a well-renowned gunsmith.
Gunsmith?
Not prop master. They had a term for it. Not gunsmith, sorry. They had a term for it, though. Fuck, what was it? It was like... fuck. Something, but yeah.
Gun armor.
Yeah, something like that.
Yeah, the armor. Everyone uses the weapons. No, fucking video game.
Yeah.
I'm still going back to the God Emperor Trump in my head.
Hey, they said it's all canon. That's their problem.
No, you don't understand. My exterminatus is the best exterminatus. No one exterminatus is like me.
Now we will head for the local server to transplant necessary information.
I don't love Hollywood. To destroy the enemy with the passcode for the local server. Oh, BG, you're being sarcastic. Okay.
What?
BG's being sarcastic. He says he loves Hollywood.
Fuck. Yeah.
Brain Dead. The game Lone is playing is... Hold on.
Zone of the Enders.
Zone of the Enders. I was gonna look it up for you.
Oh no, level 3s. I'm so fucking scared. I'm a level 2. Oh, they're one level above me. I'm so scared.
Is that a... Wait, okay.
Is that a cock?
Kinda, it's a cockpit. The cockpit. That is a very unfortunate place to put a cockpit. I'm like, okay. That's just that. Come on, it's my dick missile.
You ever see like some of those, like old like some of those, like really weird Transformers where they do something odd, like kind of like that?
Yeah. The kitchen bots. Is that what you're talking about?
That, but like I think it's the Japanese G1 show. I like this crane truck, but when he transformed to a robot,
crane was his dick.
Yeah. I think that was part of the 5 Decepticons that came to one.
No, Combiner? I don't think that was the...
I thought that was an Autobot, that's from what I've heard, though.
Is that Long Arm? Combiner? That meant to be Long Arm?
Might have been. Because I know at that point, the American show already ended. It was kind of after that. Yeah, kind of weird, but Japan kind of does like Transformers.
Yeah, despite
it's Japan.
Despite Transformers being a knockoff of the GoBots, it's kind of weird. Well,
or knockoff of GoBots, but a lot of the original toys were like based off like Japanese, was it Macross? I know, like, what is it? One of them was Macross. Others were just rebranded Japanese, like robot toy, or like no, they were mech toys. That's why the original Ironhide and Ratchet looked so weird, like their toys did, because they were actually mechs.
You know, this game is giving me vibes of the OG fucking Armor Core.
To an extent. It's just the HD and all that. It just looks like Metal Gear, but that's because they use the same engine.
Yeah. No, this reminds me a lot of Armor Core 3. Was it the Wings of Raven or Wings of Rebellion?
Wings of Rebellion. I haven't played those. So.
Wings of Redemption.
Look here. Listen.
Look, listen. I suck at this game because the controller.
Fuck you. Okay, fuck you. Yeah, that's a menu item.
Why the fuck I can't hurt these people? Like, no, I shot him multiple times with the bolter gun and does zero damage. They take damage, but their HP isn't going down, so I have to, like... There's something going on with microwave them. Energy from the outer EPS system, mandated
by the Environmental Protection Law. The enemy Microman. It was Microman. I know it was based on robots.
Oh crap!
What? It's dangerous?
I messed up a fight.
Being within the energy field
is like being in a microwave oven. Don't worry. A little bit of lead ain't gonna hurt nobody.
Was there a mech game where you play as the president and some? Are you talking about Metal Gear Revengeance?
Metal Gear Rising Revengeance. The hell is that? By turning these two antennas to face each other, the enemy has created a massive microwave energy field in the center. Metal Gear Revengeance, what the fuck?
I said Revergence.
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 Is that virtual Revergence?
That's a nice argument, Center. Why don't you back it up with a source? My source is that
sources
I made it.
I made it the fuck up. We can weaken the EPS energy flow, if not stop it. Metal Wolf Chosen Chaos.
Unicron Trilogy had GoBots. Had the Minicons, actually. Get your facts straight.
Oh yeah, I think I have the Oh, I have some of the original Armada comics.
Oh,
some of the old Dreamwave stuff.
Oh, badass. Awesome.
I also have the G1 Spider-Man crossover too. Issue number 3.
The little Marvel thing they got going on because Marvel published it. Yeah, that's awesome.
Yeah.
Oh yeah. So I was reading online as I always do. Somebody apparently doesn't understand that they're like, oh, Disney can sue them because of Spider-Man. I'm like, Spider-Man isn't owned by Disney. It's owned by Sony.
Okay, who actually holds the copyright anymore? I'm so confused on that.
It's Sony.
Okay.
It is Sony.
Them completely, or like, they're still sharing it?
It's shared. No. For Spider-Man himself, it is shared. And for everything else, like, they got this weird deal going on. Like, the reason why MJ is Michelle Jones and, like, most of the characters aren't in the MCU is, like, for, like, rights things. Like Peter Parker himself, Aunt May herself, those are shared, I believe. Everyone else, Sony is going to be, like, they're holding tightly to the chest.
Yeah.
I think, like, you pretty much saw that with, like, Madam Web, basically. Where, like, they don't even mention Peter by name in that movie. they don't mention Aunt May by name either. So, yeah.
Because they legally could not.
It was a weird rights thing, yeah. Even though they own the rights, yet they couldn't for that movie. But that movie's a total fucking...
But the only rights that they do own is the Marvel Spider-Man movie. Spider-Man, that's the one they own the rights to, but they can't like willy-nilly always use it. They have to like ask Sony.
It's a joint thing. Yeah, Sony has to portion of the profits.
Yeah.
Copyright law fun?
Yeah, it is. It's a nightmare.
But hey, you know what? We got Steamboat Willie. That's all that matters.
Sony's only the movies, yeah. I believe cartoon-wise, I think that's Disney still, I think. Because I believe, because Spider-Man... That came out like, what was it, like 2016 some shit? Like that animated show by Man of Action, which does not look like Man of Action at all, just shows you that that company rise and fell, but that's a rant for another day. If y'all want to hear me rant about that, link in the comments. But that was on Disney XD. That wasn't on one of Sony's little branch things.
Doesn't Sony also have the games, though?
I think so, to an extent.
Oh, okay.
Well, I'm pretty sure. Okay. Were some of the multi-platform? I'm dead-ass yes. certain. Yeah, okay, I'm not crazy. Because Bashar
Dimensions... Oh, I think some were, yeah.
The older ones were. The recent ones are not. The recent ones are not.
Yeah, because they had I think Spider-Man was in Disney Infinity, I think.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, I think they had, yeah.
Yeah.
But they had to ask Sony's permission.
Oh, fucking, he said Midnight Suns, too. I forgot about that, yeah.
Yeah, yeah. Universal still have Hulk? I don't think so.
I think not for a while.
Yeah, no, I mean, I think that was recent that those rights expired to an extent. I don't know. Like, as if it matters now, the MCU is shit.
No one cares anymore.
No one cares anymore. Like, I think the only thing that might be somewhat good and I'm somewhat holding out for is Daredevil Born Again. But even then, I'm like, no, Drew Goddard. No Drew Goddard, so I'm expecting that show script to suck. It's cool to see John back. John's back. Cox is back. I think 90% of the cast is back. So, yeah. But even then, the writers team are not the same, and Drew is not. Okay. Drew Goddard's not there. Okay. So yeah, that's.
According to this, the owner of Spider-Man and Doctor Strange is Steve Ditko.
Steve Ditko? He's not...
Ditko?
Ditko. D-I...
Ditko. Steve Ditko. That's how you pronounce it.
Ditko, dude.
That's how it is. Stop being dumb.
I'm dyslexic.
Yeah, we know. They're retarded excuse. Hey, I'm retarded, so it's okay for me to be wrong. Well, you're wrong! But yeah, he was one of the creators, actually.
Yeah, he owns the copyright.
And even he also created Iron Man's Sony yellow and red design.
Yep. Mm-hmm. But he can't claim that because he is not the original producer of that. So the person who owns Iron Man, they can use that design because he gave them permission. From what I'm understanding, he owns Spider-Man and Doctor Strange. Like, he owns the comic book rights now. Because Marvel was trying to get a hold of it. He's like, no.
Or it must be his estate then, because he died 2018.
Yeah, mm-hmm. Because after that, it went to his family now. Like, he owns
his
family
estate. Owns that. Yeah.
So what is, by the way, what's Death in the Family about, the comic run done by Scott Snyder?
Oh, damn, we're finally asking that. Oh, yeah, Death in the Family was this run that was, Scott Snyder's little run. Shut the fuck up. Shut it. But, it's fine, I love you, Vincent. But, it was this run back in New 52. I don't know if you remember that, Trench, but... It was basically DC.
Comics.
Yeah, yeah. DC's little reboot, quote unquote, of the DC universe where they incorporate a bunch of characters and stuff like that. And that's where they brought some Vertigo characters into the main universe. That's how Constantine became more prevalent. That's where the Constantine comic comes in. And then you have him cross over Superman, Batman, stuff like that, and Evil and stuff like that. But Scott Snyder's run. Now, Death in the Family is I believe, how many issues in? It's a good ways in. And it basically it follows up on another story in Detective Comics number 2 or number 1, one of the earlier ones. And what happens in that is that Joker gets his face cut off by Dollmaker, and it gets left behind, and he flat out disappears for a solid year or something like that. And then at the start of the comic, he comes back and he's terrifying.
He wears it like kind of like stapled on and all that, and then
I've never seen the image of that.
Kind of spoiler and all that. His daughter kills him, and then she starts wearing the face.
I thought it was Quinn that killed him.
In New 52, it's like this weird thing. Like Joker's daughter is like this weird thing because I think they retconned this at some point where she's not actually his daughter. She's just someone who says she's his daughter. Like New 52 is a weird cookie patch, to be honest. Like there's some good comics, there's some shit comics in that lineup.
And also Death of the Family, we get Cassandra Cain as Batgirl.
Oh, okay. That's the redhead, right?
No, that's the silent
one. That's the silent one. That's
the one who can't talk.
Yeah, that's the other one. I don't think that was not Death of the Family. That was like a different comic, and I think that was before New 52 even came out. Right, let me find. Oh god damn it, fucking hell.
What?
I love that image so much. That Scott and god damn it, the artists, they fucking nailed it. It is nightmare inducing what they did to Mr. J. I'm gonna show
you. Well, he had it coming a long time ago. Oh yeah, that image, yeah. Like I said, in all fairness, he had that coming a long time ago.
Fucking hell, that Scott made the Joker terrifying. And what the storyline was, you had like Joker essentially.
I'm sorry, I have to point it out. I'm not talking about the one with the C. I'm talking about the one with the K. That Cassie Kane. There's a difference.
Oh, that Cassie. Shit.
Yes.
Oh, that one.
Think I was talking about Cassie Kane. I'm talking about the one who is not the daughter of Taskmaster. I'm talking about the one that is the daughter of, I can't remember, but she has black hair instead of blonde.
Lady
Death. Thank you.
Lady Deathstrike.
Yeah. No, fuck. She's on the tip of my tongue. She's part of the
League of Shadows.
League of Shadows. She works with Aloe Ghul. She's like, she's up there with Ra's al
Ghul. Lady Deathstrike. Wait. No. Damn it. That's Marvel. Fuck.
Not Lady Death.
Lady Shiva. That's her name.
Thank you. Yes.
I just said that.
Oh, yeah. Fuck. Shiva, yeah, Lady Shiva.
We didn't hear you. We didn't hear you, Trench.
Yeah, my man.
We didn't hear you. Yeah, Lady Shiva.
I thought you were yelling at me about it being Marvel. I thought I was confused for a moment.
No. I was saying Lady Deathstrike was Marvel. Like that's why the name kept popping up. That's the X. Oh. That's the Wolverine villain. But Lady Shiva is the one. Like who's one of the best fighters in the DC universe? But back to Death and the Family. It basically like made Joker terrifying. Like at that point, like he's his most unpredictable. Well, actually, Endgame technically was his most unpredictable, but like that was when like Batman was on his heels basically. And at a point, like he ends up getting like Alfred captured. Later on, he ends up getting the entire Bat family like wrapped up, and like Batman like escapes like through his teeth, like. Barely manages to get out, and like there's just so much nightmare imagery in that comic. Like it's just so well done, and legit is one of my favorite storylines from Scott. Like I don't know if I can rank them right now. Like Quarter Bowels, Death of the Family, and Batman Endgame, but like I don't know. Like it flip flops for me. To be honest, though, I like his run. I know some people really do not like Scott Snyder's run. People say, oh, Wall of Text, Batman's an idiot, that type of stuff. I enjoyed it. I think it's well done. I think he added new things to it. But yeah, that's me in that regard, though. But yeah, I do recommend it. I do recommend the comic, though.
All right. Do you know the one he did where it's Batman, but I don't have to go and look for the comic, but it starts out with him, and it's him and this guy he's with, and getting hunted down by pretty much every, like, the entirety of his rogues gallery, and even civilians try to capture him, just like a big bounty on his head.
Is that a recent one?
Or maybe I'll have to see the year.
I think it is a recent one. And also the answer, Joker's daughter, it's Dwella Dent. She also goes by Scarecrow's daughter, Catwoman's daughter, Catgirl, Cat.
Wait, what?
Catwoman's daughter. So basically, it's this really weird. She's like, she thinks she's these supervillains' daughters, but she's not.
Yeah, I figured as much. Just says that.
Look like Catwoman's kind of funny. Not gonna lie.
Yeah, Catgirl's. Scarecrow and Riddler's daughter, Penguin's daughter, Car Girl.
Wait, Harley. wait, what? Scarecrow?
Scarecrow's daughter. Or Scarecrone. C-R-O-N.
Oh, Chrome. Chrome. I'm like, how did Scarecrow pull women? How did he do that?
Easy. He used aphrodisiac, I guess.
Fair enough.
I want to see my mask. To answer Pinita Alavaca's question, I have not read Zarsky's run. To be honest, I don't think I've read anything that's come out recently on DC or Marvel in the last like 3 or 4 or 5 years now at this point, to be honest. Like, at a point I think I just stopped caring. I stopped bothering to catch up. Now,
yeah,
I'm looking, like, right now I'm hearing some mixed things on it as usual. Like, oh god, what run was it? Was it 10? Batman? Ah, shit.
Yeah, honestly, I think just indie stuff just honestly is better.
Indie stuff, Vertigo stuff, the offshoot stuff, yeah.
Yeah, because, fuck, is, I want to say there's one comic that I've read that might be Vertigo. Is that what I'm thinking of? Because Vertigo is a company, right?
Vertigo is like, yeah, that was DC's, like, I remember bringing that up in one of my vids, is that it's DC's like little offshoot, is where their darker stuff usually goes, the more adult stuff usually goes in. Like, right. At a point it was in the DC universe, but that's since been changed. There are some comics that in the DC universe on it, but as the publishing continued, like, you had like comics that like weren't attached at all. Like, you had like Watchmen, you had like American Vampire, Preacher, that type of stuff.
All right. I was incorrect. It was a Dark Horse, the comic I was thinking of, but yeah.
Dark Horse, yeah.
Of course, Dark Horse. Like, Dark Horse Studios.
Yeah, they make some good stuff, though. They do make
good stuff. Their Star Wars stuff is still the best.
They also make the Witcher comic book series.
Don't they also translate Berserk?
Yeah, they did, at a point. They were one of the translators, yeah. I think that changed.
I guess we're over to Studio Madhouse. And then, yeah, it's just... Berserk stuff is really complicated. It's just like, what's going on? And you know, it's like a fucking shit. Yeah. A lot of shit's going on.
Well, next chapter's coming out, I think, in a week.
True.
Hmm?
And then Lolly's gonna get money again. I mean, that's what people pay for, is this Berserk stuff.
Well, that's his big thing. That's his tism.
That is it. Yeah.
Do you like ever kind of look into the artists, or like ever know any of the artists for the comics, or just stick to writers only?
Depends. There are some artists that I like, regardless. But primarily, I do try to pay attention to the writers as often as I can, though.
Yeah.
Because that's generally like where the quality really, really is, though. Like, one. You know, like the guy who did like One Punch Man and Mob Psycho 100, like, his art isn't that best, but his writing is like on point. So that's a good example.
All right. You ever heard of Francesco Francavilla?
Who? Sorry, say that again.
Yeah.
The artist for Night of the Ghoul. Probably not.
Oh, I looked at a bit of Night of the Ghoul. I'm gonna read that at some point. That's on the list, but as for the artist, I don't think I recognized him. I don't think I recognize his work, his catalog. Art? Yeah.
Alright.
Yeah, I have no clue what the fuck you're talking about.
That was just a comic I got into.
Alright. Well, I'm like, Lone's the comic book guy, I'm the video game guy.
Oh my.
The fuck am I then?
I don't know.
I don't. You're Trench. Like, what more do you need to be?
God damn, I did again. God damn it, this girl.
You're the Star Wars nerd, honestly. Let's be real.
Give me a second. Give me a second. We'll see what I'm.
Oh shit.
I'm not a simp. I'm not a simp, guys. I'm not a simp. Leave me alone.
You are a simp.
No, I'm not.
Oh. I'm based in red. Well, I dropped something I shouldn't drop. I'm a professional. Which most of the Lord Farquaad meet of like, look, he's a simp.
I fucking dead. that's the epitome of she fucking knows she's fucking hot as hell. You know she's hot as hell. Like holy shit.
He has that look of like, I'll stab your tires and then I'll say I'm sorry.
That is a funny shirt to have, though, I'm not gonna lie.
BG, you're mad about how much time you waste on YouTube. So am I. I have looked at it. According to my Switch, I have logged over 8,000 hours on YouTube.
All right, enough admiring. Enough of that. Enough. Hopefully, that's the last time I gog about Sydney on stream. Jesus Christ.
Smells like there's a lot of simping going on in this chat.
God fucking damn it.
I mean, you could do the same shit when I start simping for somebody, but...
I mean, every generation, every time has them. Like at one point it was Megan Fox, another point it was what's another one?
Good point.
Megan Fox. I didn't see the appeal of Megan Fox. I'm gonna be completely honest with you.
Emily Blunt was another one. That was another one.
Who is she?
Charlize Theron. Emily Blunt. Ever watch Live Die Repeat?
Well yep, her, I remember now.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Charlize Theron, Michelle Rodriguez, put on that list too. Just a Bill Weapon. Oh crap, I forgot where it was, like down too, wasn't it? But yeah. No, Penny, I wasn't jerking, because if I was jerking off, you would have heard me pull my shorts down. You would have heard me grunting. Hey, no, I wasn't.
Load, hands on the keyboard.
Yes, I have his monitor on.
Load, hands where I can see them.
Fuck.
I detect a vector trap. It appears there is an object in
this area. He's not pulling an FPS diesel. It is one of the
Metatron related. Oh! DSP.
He's gonna shake it like a fucking wildebeest in the wild. When you apply high energy and high speed
rotation to Metatron, you can observe an effect. That.
So, before, okay, FPS diesel,
point of compression.
He did a live stream where he went live while he was jerking it and started it and was like, oh, camera's on? Snort, snort.
That's DSP, ain't that?
Yeah.
Oh. You said MS Diesel, whatever the fuck.
Sorry, I'm just...
Vincent moment. But yeah, that was Darkseid Phil. Yeah. I agree with Vincent. Maybe I'm in the minority, maybe hot take, like Megan Fox, like that she very much was. Like she was not like one of my crushes growing up. Like if anything, it was Keira Knightley. Keira Knightley was one of my
Thank you.
07, get another 07, man, that was good. Maybe it's the filmography. Maybe it's filmography, but I don't know. She looked good in Transformers.
Yeah.
Of course she looked good because it was plastic.
Well, fair enough. Yeah, fair enough. Like Kira may have not have had too much up top, but like she was gorgeous.
Like how much we talking? Like was she flat or was she like decent?
She was like decent. Like she had to wear like a push up bra and I think in the movie she was in, like they had to Photoshop her breasts in the King Arthur poster. Like, you can look that up.
Yeah.
Fuck! I'm kind of pissed that I lost the state. Like now my mic's gonna be like flopping around like blown.
It could be worse.
Oh, what's worse is that we can start hearing the swing and punching and all that. Like, no.
Fair enough.
I prefer my equipment to be stiff.
Man, why'd you gotta say that, Jeremy, or some whatever your name is? DSP did outlive Rooster Teeth. That hurts.
God, damn, he did, didn't he? Shit.
He did.
It cannot be canceled. Like he paid $1,000 just to see his cat. Just to see his cat on street. The dude has evaded the IRS. ESP cannot be canceled even by the IRS. And those guys got Al Capone.
They got Al Capone, even Joker was scared of him.
I'm crazy enough to go after the Batman, but the IRS is where I draw the line.
Yeah, I saw that video you posted, though, of the OG guys playing Halo Combat Evolved.
Yeah, that hurts. Like,
I still wish, like, I know they hate him because politics, but I still wish they invited Joel. Like, yeah, he was one of them.
He was. Two-based. He was two-based.
You know, if they didn't,
they'd
still have a community going on that's run by porn.
Yeah, maybe. Did you see in that video, though, that Bernie had a visitor sticker?
I said, yeah, I did.
Oh, okay, yeah.
It was sad. Well, like I said, if they didn't listen to Tumblr lights and actually listen to the audience that watched their show, they would have had a better fucking long running. And if they didn't become a greedy corporation like everyone else, they would have fucking been fine. But no, they had to have Rooster Teeth first. It was $10 a month, and then honestly, they got fucked over by that. Season 3 went downhill with Ruby and all that because they weren't following. Honestly, let's be real, they weren't following Monty's fucking vision.
Nope, not even close.
Okay, chat. Megan Fox, Keira Knightley. Megan Fox, Keira Knightley. Megan Fox, Keira Knightley. Keira Knightley, I'm sorry.
Wait, what?
17 in that movie.
In the first film, during shooting production, she was 17. In the second and third, she was like in her 20s.
I will say second movie. Okay, second movie is when I found her hot, because she is kind of hot.
Like, holy shit.
And there's no denying, like, now she's kind of cute.
Come on, I'm
sorry, but I gotta stick for the Asian lady, so.
Yeah, of course you do.
You're a nightly BG. Fucking swine.
What?
BG in chat.
Hmm.
Yeah, BG, you're right. DSP will be still fucking begging for money even though the universe has ended.
Yeah, he will.
Oh, whoa. Oh god, fucking lasers.
We have shot down the enemy. And I agree, the first two parts of the game will be a fucking moment.
Thank you.
Let's start mid.
Yeah. It's because, well, yeah, it's kind of the opposite. I think I had this funny thought where, like, it's the opposite of Michael Bay, Alex Kurtzman, and Bob Schrupp, or whatever the fuck his name is, the other writer. Like, they were the worst people to get for Transformers. Meanwhile, for Pirates of the Caribbean, Gore Verbinski, Ted, Rossio and Elliot. I know their last names. I forgot their first names. Like, Gore Verbinski, Rossio and Elliot, like, those guys are, like, that's the franchise right there. Without them, you take one out, man, it's gonna suffer. Like, Verbinski.
Yeah.
Hans Zimmer, yeah.
Fucking Hans Zimmer, but I still call him the Pirates of the Caribbean thing to this day.
Yeah. Well, then they went to make more movies, but like Johnny Depp was just done with it all.
No, it was a mix. Disney it was, yeah, Disney, because the Amber Heard shit. Remember that?
And they still haven't apologized for that shit.
Nope, no one has.
No, a few people have to Johnny Depp personally.
Oh, okay. I don't think any corporations have though.
As a corporation.
Fair enough.
When will the corporation ever side with a man that isn't fucking gay?
Yeah, good point. And then, O.J. Simpson. Because didn't Norm MacDonald get kicked out of, what was it? It was something because he kept making
his
those
comedy,
jokes.
His little comedy show because he kept taking hot shots at O.J. He continued to do it. He continued to do it. Though. And those are funny as hell.
Man, I watched the one where it's like, You can't have the award taken away from you, unless you kill your wife and the waiter. That was awesome.
Yeah, like, oh my god, you can't make fun of that shit. And you're like, yeah, you can.
This just then, murder is now legal in the state of California.
This just in. Make not anymore. Like fucking shit. Like people are getting away with murder.
Man, I wish he lived to see the to see OJ die. I wish he did.
Oh god, that would have been funny as hell. God damn.
That would have been awesome.
That would have been awesome. I wish we didn't live in this freaking timeline. That would have been funny as fuck.
Norman MacDonald would have said, well, OJ's wife can finally rest.
Legit, that connects to hearing him say that.
At the very least, everybody made that joke, so I'm happy about that at least.
Everyone made that joke. I can actually hear him say that.
He wanted to.
He was straight up saying, he was like, what? I'm right.
Yeah.
I'm off to destroy Canada. They had it good for too long.
Alright, now I'm off to destroy Canada.
They had it good for too long. Yeah. What the
fuck? I don't understand you in this fucking communist
government. No offense, but that sounds like a bunch of fucking commie godly gook. He just said that.
He was a national treasure.
Oh, god damn it. Fucking Sarah Silverman.
Yeah.
God. Fucking add that to the 94,
Donald Trump on 94 charges. That's 94 million votes he hits.
Actually, I quite couldn't see him making that joke.
Okay. Marshall's in chat.
No.
Oh, shit. How
you doing? I need to change the damn thing.
Wait, what? Everyone, stop talking about stuff.
Okay, there we go. Damn, I hate this thing. Nothing. It's because I just need to position myself because these damn pixel pervert acts. See, god damn it. Any video game crushes? Not right. Well, not out of the games now. Now that's not Stellar Blade at the moment.
Honestly, Kate from Fallout 4. Well, also Veronica from New Vegas, but that was before I figured out her, yeah.
Oh yeah, she's a lesbian?
Yeah. Ah, fuck.
Damn it. Ursula from Pathfinder Wrath of the Righteous.
Fair enough.
Yeah, she is the succubus, but if you do the good path and follow her, it becomes true love and all that.
Oh yeah, I heard about that.
Yeah.
Maybe Chloe. You know what? I'll add Chloe. Chloe's on that. She's one. Chloe from Uncharted. From Uncharted.
Panam. Was it? Yeah, Panam.
Panam.
Man. Yeah.
I wonder why everyone focuses on Panam.
Yeah. I really like Julie too.
She has a dump truck.
She has a fucking bakery.
It's not a dump truck, it's a fucking 18-wheeler, let's be honest.
Yeah. I'll admit though, it was pretty creative to have the scene in a tank. It was very creative.
Yeah, it was.
The funniest shit ever is if you show up in the Alcatraz camp, your character's naked and you're like, nothing going on, guys. And I'm just like, picturing, I was like, just imagine that, you're walking out of camp, next thing you know, your dick is out.
Well, actually, the weird thing is, when I played, I think it automatically put my clothes back on after the cutscene.
I think it should have stayed off.
Nah, dang. It was one of the glitch things.
Or, it might be because I think it did turn nudity off. I could be wrong. Or wait, maybe not.
So alone, did you help Songbird or not?
Didn't we have this kind of conversation like before, didn't I? Oh wait.
With the yeah.
Did you finish it? Did you feel regret?
I'm not finishing it yet. Yeah, I beat the game. This was a while ago, and we did stream about this. And I betrayed Songbird, and I went with Reed.
That's good.
Yeah, that was at that point. That was at the we were at that engine place. Right, and you have
I told you, don't trust Songbird.
Yeah, and like she, you.
She is you.
Yeah, you said you practically pulled a no Russian on one of the missions.
Yeah.
Some point, and I have been replaying, I just haven't been replaying it for a while, so I have to get back to it soon. But I have been replaying the DLC, so yeah, and I've been planning to go with Songbird this time around. I just haven't gone to it yet.
Yeah, and then you understand why I don't like the Songbird experience. It, like, holy shit, that was unneeded.
You can see two EPS antennas on the mountains ahead of. Yeah, I'll probably just go, was it NUSA? That's probably what I'll do.
Oh yeah, if you side with the NUSA, take the oath and all that, Johnny starts giving off. I was like, man, you just really sold yourself out. And then
he was shit talking me. It's like, man, fuck you.
I thought it was funny because the V I did where I took the oath was a corpo V, so I was like, dude,
same.
Oh my god, it was on my chair this whole time. I'm looking around on my floor like fucking Pippa when she sees something. It's on my chair.
When you beat the DLC, does that end the game or
No, it gives you a different option. If you go with Reed, you take the surgery to get the relic removed
out of your head. All right.
Yeah, but you still need to beat the main main story when you get to that point.
Oh, no.
Like when you side with Reed the entire time, turn Songbird over, that type of stuff, you will get that other ending.
Okay.
But you can also do that ending straight up if you wait a few days. He was like, hey, I got in contact with the NUSA operation. They're ready to do the operation. And you can literally end the game right then and there.
Yeah.
While you're still in Act 2. That's the fun
shit. Oh, in Act 2? I didn't realize that.
Oh, that's cool. Yeah. Okay.
Yeah, I did that. I was like, I still have to do these acts and all that. I still had to do Judy's quest. I think I literally didn't say Eve, so I literally had to do that. I still had to do the Reaver quest line. I had to do Carry Your Dimes. I still had to talk to Rogue and all that shit.
Doesn't just Eve always die though, no matter what?
Yeah.
That sucks.
I still had to give Rogue the money to start those quests, so I literally did Mama Brigitte at level 30, and I was like, okay, cool, let's do this, and then I finished the DLC, and I was like, I can just wait a few days, fuck yeah, let's see what happens, and that happens. So I was like, oh, I can literally beat the game in Act 2.
Yeah.
And let's go back to Fallout TV show. Do you think they're ever going to do something for Minton Squad? Like, have a little Easter egg for him?
I don't think he was big enough for them to notice. Kind of sad to think about that, but I don't think he was.
I mean, they did it for the one guy who had cancer.
Maybe. I guess maybe then. It would really depend on them if they care enough.
They probably will, because he was a big influence. He did big Bethesda games.
Yeah, it just matter. It just depends. Like, it just entirely depends on if they give enough of a fuck to do it, though. Kind of sad thing.
And just this is where the real game begins. You just have a bucket right there called Paul.
I just have a little cat with, like, maybe with mittens on it, and just name Paul or something.
Min Squad. No, it's a bucket. His joke was always buckets.
Oh yeah, I remember now. Yeah.
Kind of sad that outlaws
did that to him. Fucking yeah. Like, it does that to a lot of people. If you're not careful. We will cease battle position.
Yeah. So, gentlemen in chat, if you're ever feeling down, don't drink a bottle. Actually seek help. Reach out. Fucking
kill yourself.
Don't kill yourself.
Fucking came messing around.
You matter. Like, you honestly do matter. Your life is worth it. Don't.
Yeah, don't.
The world become less dull if you do.
Yeah.
Because you guys are part of our community and all that. I honestly do care about you guys. I want to make sure you guys are doing fine. See how you guys are doing. Like, you matter. You guys are the reason why we have 1,000 subscribers. Like, you guys. It's all you and Chad.
Not lie, Vincent. That was a great speech. Great speech. But while you were talking about it, I saw fucking Derek's chat. I'm sorry. Yeah, you do matter.
Yeah, you do matter.
mean, what's AOT2?
What's AOT2?
No, Marshall was playing it.
Attack on Titan?
Yeah, they have several.
Yeah. The second one is honestly the best one.
Fuck. Yeah, okay.
We have obtained the item.
Dr. Jack has been released. Just remember, guys, if life beating you down, don't take it like a man, and then you turn around and fuck life's mom. Because that's what real men do.
You know who else? Oh, actually, no, that doesn't make any sense. Never mind.
You know who else fucked my mom?
My mom. You know who else got cheated on? Why did she leave me, bro?
It just isn't fair.
It isn't fair. I did everything for her.
Unironically, he would do that kind of joke, though.
I mean, they had to make him eat a picture of his foot to make it look like his mom.
Say she looks beautiful. We are heading for the
outer area of the battle zone. Well, it was also, wasn't he also smart, too, but they did that joke to make him dumb again?
No. Muscle Man was always Muscle Man. I don't think he has like a...
There it is.
I thought like he was like a professor for a little bit or something.
No, that was a joke. Like... That was a joke. That was like a joke episode. Remember, like that was like that was like when reality wasn't moving around, that type of stuff. It was like Gary Bobby Ferguson Jr. was messing things around.
Oh yeah, speaking about Gary, that character, he's based off of somebody who's like, "I'll sue you if you say I didn't win." Like,
yeah, the famous cheater. Got his name, but I know what you're talking about.
Oh, the Pac-Man guy.
Yeah.
No, it was Donkey Kong.
Oh, No, it was Pac-Man.
No, it was Donkey Kong.
It was Pac-Man because I want to say that's what the short dude was based on in Pixels.
Yes, but it was Donkey Kong that he was talking that he said he has the world record on.
I thought it was Pac-Man because in the documentary where they also mentioned the Pac-Man glitch. It was
Donkey Kong. Mm-hmm. Donkey Kong record holder. Yeah.
All right.
Billy Mitchell. Yeah.
Yeah. Okay.
I do agree with Marshall. The ODM gear in Attack on Titan 2 is a lot better than the first one because you can actually maneuver with it.
Okay.
As a hint, Marshall, check out the scythes because if you upgrade the scythes to high enough, nearly every kill you get with them, every hit you can get with them, is an insta kill. We will cease battle position.
Oh no.
I have been staring back. Am I?
What? We have dropped down the
enemy. What
are we talking about?
Is the sky falling?
Is it sky? I knew so. Yeah. It's the end of the world. God, it took me years to get why people didn't like that movie. I was like, because the father is a bit of a dick at a point. The fact he doesn't stand up for
Chicken
him.
Little? Dad,
Chicken Little, yeah. Everyone's just such a... Yeah.
The dad is a dick, but he becomes better.
Yeah.
Like, that's called character growth.
Yeah. But... Yeah, that's one of those where like it takes me a minute to get. Oh, I see why. Like getting older and realizing why certain like why you heard like my friends didn't were not allowed to watch shows like Invader Zim and Foster's Home for Imaginary Friends. Invader Zim because he acted like an actual toddler. It's Invader Zim, but it's because Grr acts like an actual toddler and the fact that Zim caves into him. And Foster's, like, Blue is a legit bad influence.
Oh, yeah, I agree with that. But you also forgot, Invader Zim has one character that everyone seems to forget. The Delicious Weenie Salesman.
Oh yeah.
Watch that show. It was pretty good.
Delicious Wheaties. The emergency EPS generator
has been destroyed. The EPS. I still remember. I learned how to ink. What? I must go. My squid family needs me.
You went 400 years. What the hell?
Who are you? Zim, who are
you? Who are you? I'm who are you? I'm who are you?
Who are you?
You're not gonna get away with what? You're not gonna what? You're not gonna what? Zim.
What?
What?
Zim!
What?
Zim! I know better now.
Oh, it's 6 o'clock where I am. Fuck, I gotta start doing laundry.
I might close this in a few minutes. back to change.
So, as a weird thing, you know how, have you guys been noticing Dr. Squatch is actually in this door now?
Oh yeah, yeah, in a few places, yeah.
The local, the Wawa near my place, I hate fucking Walmart. It's like $6 for one bar.
Alright.
It's cheaper than the website.
Yeah.
The website's like $9. So I grabbed some, and holy shit. The coconut castaway? I highly very recommend cheap. It. And apparently they have a female brand line under a different name. And I was trying to get some for my mom, and they have mango smelling one.
Don't forget to take out your trash cans.
I know.
What?
That was my weekly reminder to take out my trash. I take it out every Sunday.
Alright.
It just helps with the ADHD.
Yeah, that makes sense.
There we go. See you later. Gordon.
But yeah, I highly recommend it. It does do a deep clean, and it doesn't leave that weird icky feeling after like regular body wash. It doesn't have that chemical residue left over on it.
All right.
So, Dr. Swatch gets Vincent's seal of approval.
All right.
So you shall with this shit.
Oh yeah, the ads. Yeah,
those were funny.
They are.
You ever have like those fucking what are they called? Like those, what are they called? The soap bars, but they're Duke soap bars.
Oh no, I haven't checked those guys out yet.
They're kind of nice. Like I know they're the whole like you know, like man soap bar, but they actually smell kind of good though.
Oh, it's like Irish Spring and all that.
No, I mean more like way. Think of like I'm trying to think of a good example. Like
the original Old Spice commercials, like with Fabio.
I've never heard those.
Oh, Fabio? Oh yeah, that was cool. What was that before Terry Crews?
Yes.
Yeah, that was before.
Oh Terry. Yeah. I remember that, yeah, alright.
Dude, the fucking Old Spice is like $13 where I'm at now. Like, holy shit. That's for the deodorant. One stick. $13. Right. So, yeah, I switched it over to old Dr. Squatcher. I was like, it's cheaper.
Yeah. I don't blame you for that.
$13 for a sprue. $400 milliliters so that's like what, 13.5 fluid ounces? Compared to a bar of soap? Like, I'd rather have the bar of soap.
Yeah.
There you go. Okay.
And guys, remember. Check your balls for cancer.
Hey, what?
Definitely.
Firmly, gently grab the sack and give it a nice squeeze.
Check if there are groves or anything like that and wear blocks.
Yeah. Man, what the fuck? Alright.
I'm promoting men healthness awareness. Because I know women won't do it.
Yeah, fair enough.
God damn it.
It's all about breast cancer and fucking breast cancer and all this. What about testicular cancer? Like, hard nuts matter do.
Yeah, you got a point there.
Yeah, no, don't skip out on the doctor's visits. If something hurts after a week, go get it checked out. Like, yeah, I understand American healthcare is not the greatest, but it's a lot better than fucking Canada's. Where
I was about to say that.
Oh, you have this rash? All right, take these meds. See me in a week. If it doesn't improve, you're dead.
Kill yourself now.
I will prescribe you death.
I wonder, do you think Canada will ever, integrate those, fucking suicide boosts from Futurama?
They already have.
Ah.
Like, this is no joke. I have a buddy I just met. He's from Canada and all that. And he's like, yeah, no, they're starting to talk about suicide boosts. And I was like, that's terrifying.
I know that one's fucked up. That's kind of horrifying that.
Yeah, Justin Trudeau won't survive the next Canadian election.
Oh, hell nah. Like, even people who are, like, left-wing don't even like him.
And they're not sorry about it.
Alright, don't blame them. It's like, yeah, nah. Because he's probably gonna get what's coming to him, if I'm being honest.
Yeah, BG, I do agree with you. US is not perfect, but we will give you it, with the healthcare we have here, is we make sure you get what you need. We're not gonna like, oh, you have a broken arm? Alright, go sit in the lobby for 6 hours, and we might see you today. Oh, I'm sorry, yeah. I could write you a recommendation, but I'm not, because I'm not. I don't feel like
yeah, like, at least some of the time, they're like, no, goddammit, you're going to get healed one way or another, motherfucker.
We still need your body for taxes. We're going to make sure you're healthy. The reason why I'm so, like, I'm on health right now is because me and my mom went to a doctor visit for her and all that. We found out that she has 23% plaque buildup in her legs. So I'm trying to, like, you know, I'm like, this is something we can easily fight. We can take care of this. We're going to be a lot more healthy. We're going to get more exercise and all that.
Damn, all right.
And she's like, she's 59 years old with 23% plaque buildup. That is actually really good. Like, it'd be better if it was zero, but this is something we can catch early on.
Yeah, it's like, yeah, you caught it early on, so at least you can fight it, you know? Yeah. Damn,
and it's not like, you know, she's going to die. It's like, it's plaque buildup. We just have to watch
it. Yeah. Which, in all fairness, if you're actively watching your diet, isn't, like, that hard.
Yeah.
Which, like, no disrespect, I just mean, like, when you're actually even just taking a glance at it, you can kind of go, like, all right, cut that.
Yeah, that's what we've been doing.
Yeah.
Like, we've slowed down. Like, we've only eat out fast food, like, twice this week. And it was, like, 4 days apart since we did it. So it's, like, yeah, it's understandable. And also, my grandmother, she was in the hospital recently because her blood sugar shot to 410.
Fuck.
That is, you go to the emergency room right fucking now. That kind of emergency.
Yeah, that kind of shit.
Yeah, because she took shots in her legs and all that to help her walk and all that. And then she was really hungry, so my little brother took her to Walmart. They ate McDonald's and she ate a Cinnabon right there in the morning and didn't tell my dad, so they didn't know. And we're trying to get her to stop drinking diet soda and drinking more water. And she's like, I hate diet. She's like, but it has no sugar. I was like, yeah, it's all the other shit that's bad for you. Diet soda's not good for you.
It's fucking, no, it's not. It is, yeah, no, it's not healthy for you.
Yeah, no. Like, and like an 88-year-old drinking diet soda, like, no, grandma, start drinking 88? Water. Yeah, she's 88 years old.
Okay, make her, like, with all due respect, make her drink water.
We've been trying, and I told my dad about GamerSups, so he's going to look into it.
Oh, GamerSups.
Yeah.
Man, I want to tell him. I want to, like, tell everybody I know about that. What the fucking marketing?
Just tell him.
I don't know, fair enough.
Some of the flavors are called Guacamole GamerFart 9000.
GamerFart, Bathwater.
Tamwater, Gamer Girl Sweat, like all these
Gamer Girl Sweat, fucking anime titties.
Anime
like
titty milk. Man, oh.
Yeah.
Emotional damage.
Emotional damage? Well, what does that taste like?
Cherry lemonade.
You know what? I'll try it.
We have Misfit Melon, like Raztaz Blueberry. Like, some of the flavors are fucking great, and I love it. You know they're starting ramen now?
Starting what?
Ramen. Like cup of noodles. Right.
Like healthy ramen normal ramen?
It is a healthier ramen and all that. It doesn't have as much sodium as a regular cup of Maruchan ramen. I believe it has 25% less.
Alright. That's interesting. I'll give him credit for that.
Yeah, it's... I'm almost 30. I gotta watch out in case my warranty on my knees break loose.
There we go.
Alright, should we call it here? It's 6:10 where I'm at. We've been doing this for like, what, 2 hours?
2.5 hours? Okay, yeah. This part's always been throwing me off. And yeah, shield, yeah, okay, yeah. I already saved earlier, I might as well just save again. Alright.
Can't save you in combat.
wait. Oh damn, I'm not right. Okay. Whatever. I mean, I saved earlier, so that's fine.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Alright. Oh no, my dad will most likely order Grandpa's ashes. My dad has that sense of humor.
Hey, Grandma, here's Grandpa's ashes. Eat it.
And it's the most stupidest thing ever, but I love... My dad sent me a t-shirt that says the first rule of gun safety is not let the government have them.
Yeah.
Don't let the government have it.
You should, you should look at the, You should show him the Unsubscribe podcast. He'll probably get a kick out of them.
Oh, he does.
Oh, hell yeah.
My dad is in fucking the gun culture. He's a gunsmith.
Oh, wait. Oh, hell yeah.
Yeah, he's his own gunsmith. He makes his own guns and fire ammunition.
So, I'm assuming you need like woodworking and metalworking skills, right, for that?
Yeah.
All right.
My dad was an electrician before all this shit. He's building rockets. Like, actual model rockets. Like, the biggest one he's built was over, I believe, 12 feet tall.
12 feet?
Feet. And it reached an altitude of 15,000?
Alright.
Yeah.
Damn.
Rockets of California, Rock 30. They did a special on my dad because he got married at a rocket convention to my stepmom.
All right.
Yeah, we also met Carrie Byron through that stuff. So that was my TV crush, was Carrie Byron.
Makes sense.
The redhead from MythBusters.
I don't remember her. I just remember the two dudes.
You remember the two dudes, but you don't
Jamie
remember.
And
well, the one Adam. Dude who had the beret and the mustache.
Jamie and Adam, yeah.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
All right. So, shall we say it on send off?
Yeah, I guess so. I guess next time I talk about. Maybe next time we stream in 2 years, we'll see who is the better crush. Hopefully in like
are we gonna have a crush battle?
Hopefully, yeah. I like that idea.
I probably have the weirdest one no one even know about.
Yeah,
okay, who?
Fucking what's her name? The actress who played the twins in Liv and Maddie. You don't know what that show is, do you?
No.
Yep. Fucking Disney XD show.
Oh,
Dave Cameron? Dove Cameron, I'm sorry.
Oh, I think Dove Cameron, yeah. Because she played the tomboy, and I thought that was cute. Oh,
yeah. I would say my Disney crush was either was Selena Gomez, and then it changed to the one chick who played Sam in iCarly.
Jeanette McCurdy.
Yeah.
I feel so bad for her. She was a crush for mine too. She got fucked up. Like, fuck her mom. Fuck that bitch. Fuck her mom.
I do have the pictures.
Man, Hollywood's a fucking hellhole.
Yeah. But I would say my big movie crush was the chick who played in Underworld.
I know her name. I know what you're talking about.
Yeah.
That's a good series of movies. The first three.
We need to talk about that movie. Just sit down and talk about it.
Watch? Okay.
Kate Beckinsale. Yeah.
Alright.
Well, in all fairness, Marshall, it was meant for women, not men, but yeah.
Yeah. Alright, beautiful people, this is where we're signing off. Until next time, tune in.
Have a good day.